are just about ready. First, let's pause for this word. W-A-B-Q.
Sizzlin' steaks and burgers hot off the grill are summertime favorites. So this summer, why not treat your family to their favorite cuts of guaranteed eagle-bonded beef? Each cut is lean, tender, and flavorful, and great on the grill. And with our everyday low meat prices, you can afford to serve your family's favorites often. Cook out for less with bonded meats from Eagle.
Every day is savings day at Eagle.
Become heavyweight champion of the world. Get into show business. Discover sunken treasure. Find
a. There are a lot of ways you could become a millionaire.
Pan for gold.
But if you're looking for an easier way, play the jackpot instant game from the Illinois State Lottery.
Marry the boss's daughter.
You could win $1 million or up to $100,000 instantly, which is much simpler than trying to
become a rock star.
Strike oil. Produce.
As a cascade of blue and yellow balloons released in center field float out over the scoreboard away from the park, that makes it look like it's going to be good for home run balls. We're just about ready to get underway here in Milwaukee for game four, the Cardinals and the Brewers. I'm Win Elliott. Vin Scully and Sparky Anderson are sitting by, ready to get going. How about it, Mr. Scully?
Thank you, Wynn. Hi, everybody, and a very pleasant good afternoon to you. It has come up a beauty at County Stadium in Milwaukee. In fact, it's hard for us to realize that you can actually sit here in your shirt sleeves and do the ball game today, far away from the thoughts of the frozen lands this time of year in Wisconsin. The first ball ceremony is rather touching. American League umpire Lou DeMuro killed this summer in a freakish automobile accident. And his four sons, along with his wife, here today throwing out the symbolic first ball. Of course, baseball is much poorer this year than perhaps ever before. We've lost five umpires in not too long a span of time. And the DeMuro boys will get this game underway. Those umpires who have passed away, Nestor Shylock, Art Passarella, Bob Stewart, John Stevens, and Lou DeMuro. And now the Milwaukee Brewers taking the field. So let's take a look at the Cardinal lineup, first of all. No changes there. That means Tommy Herr at second base, Ken Obergefell at third, and Keith Hernandez at first. George Hendrick in right field. Darryl Porter behind the plate. Lonnie Smith will be in left field. Dane Orge, left-hand batter, is the designated hitter. Willie McGee, and boy, they know about him now. He's in center field. And Ozzie Smith hitting ninth at shortstop. The pitcher is Dave LaPointe. LaPointe, 6'3", 205-pound left-hander, 9-3 with the Cardinals. He came in the deal that sent, among other people, Simmons, Fingers, and Vukovic to Milwaukee. He came over here with Sixto Lescano, Larry Sorensen, and Dave Green. And LaPointe, a rather remarkable kid. In fact, by the time he was 22 years old, he had a victory in each league. And if you're a trivia buff, that might be the youngest pitcher ever to experience that feat. He is a winner. Throughout his career, he has never had a losing record in professional ball. That's Dave LaPointe out of Glens Falls, New York. He's only 23 years old. Now let's take a look at the Brewers. Paul Molitor at third, and Robin Yount, the shortstop. Cecil Cooper at first. Ted Simmons behind the plate. Gorman Thomas in center field. Ben Ogilvy will be in left. Don Money is the designated hitter instead of Roy Howell, with a left-hander going. Charlie Moore is in right field, and Jim Gampner at second base. Moose Haas, Brian Edmund Haas. And the first thing, if you've never seen him before and you hear the nickname Moose, you figure he's a big guy. Well, he's not really very big. He's only 6 feet, 170 pounds, but the word is that he was a rather large baby at birth, and he got the nickname from there. Brian Edmund Haas, 11-8. But those are the numbers. Let's find out about him. Sparky, your club battled him during the year. What kind of a pitcher is he?
Well, he has the best arm on the Milwaukee club as far as he's got a real good fastball, Ben, and he's got a good breaking ball. He's got an exceptional split-finger fastball. He can throw that, but his only problem has been that he doesn't get it over enough. If he got it over like Suter gets it over, he could be just an outstanding pitcher. I still believe, as time goes on and in the future, he is going to be just an excellent pitcher.
Well, he's only 26 years old. You figure he's just starting out, even though he's been pitching with Milwaukee really since the tail end of 1976.
I believe he's a lot like Andujar. You know, they had those periods where they struggled along a little bit, but he's going to all of a sudden just blossom. He has the arm to just be an outstanding pitcher.
And he has to have the fingers to throw that split-fingered pitch. And in his background, you find out that he is, among other things, a locksmith and an amateur magician. So he's probably got very good finger dexterity.
Well, he better be a good magician today because the Cardinals look like they're starting to put things together.
Well, the last game that he pitched, you might remember in the championship series, he had 5 1/3 innings of no-hit ball. He went in to weaken and staggered and got a 9-5 win. But now let's get to the ball game. And Tommy Herr, with only one hit in the series, he's hitting under 100. Switch hitter batting left-handed. And Moose Haas delivers fastball for a strike. 0-1. Haas had a big stretch in July where he was 4-0. And for whatever reason, he excelled on the road, particularly against the East and at night. Haas looks into Ted Simmons, right end already, and comes back 0-1. And Tommy Herr looks at another strike in the count 0-2. The Brewers tried to take their defeat last night just about the same way the Cardinals accepted that 10-0 overwhelming defeat in St. Louis. It's just one game, and they didn't really feel any phrases like backs against the wall had to be used either. Naturally, if they win today, they're even. Moose Haas checking with Simmons. The outfield on Tommy Herr just about straight away, but they pinch the middle. And he looks at strike three called, and he can't believe it. But Dave Phillips, who lives in St. Louis, by the way, the plate umpire calls him out. And Herr runs his bat on the ground as if to say it was that far inside. One away, and the batter is Ken Obergfeld. Obergfeld, the left-hand hitting third baseman, formerly a second baseman, shifted over after being injured. And Obergfeld is hitting 300 in the series. 3-for-10 with an RBI and a run scored. Haas looks to Simmons, who sets a target for him. The right-hander ready and delivers in a little high this time, ball one. Dave Phillips, we told you he's a St. Louis native. He's the plate umpire. Satch Davidson of the National League is at first. Jim Evans of the American League at second. Lee Wire of the National League at third. Bill Haller, senior umpire of the American League, on the left field line. And John Kibler on the right field line. Obergfeld fouls it away. Dave Phillips, who was born in St. Louis and lives in Lake St. Louis, working his second World Series. He's also worked two league championship series and the 1977 All-Star Game. He's a crew chief. He started attending Al Summers umpiring school at the age of 20, and he went to Southeast Missouri College. There's a shot just fair over first and down the line, and on his way for extra bases, Ken Obergfeld. Picking the ball up is Charlie Moore, and Obergfeld will hold with a double just over the bag and down the line. So a one-out double by Ken Obergfeld, and the Cardinals set up shop as Keith Hernandez and then George Hendrick trying to pick him up. Hernandez is the hungriest of the Cardinal hitters. Keith is 0-for-11 in the series. He has also committed two errors. He has been on base just once when he got a base on balls. But, of course, National Leaguers know how well Hernandez hits, so it's a tribute to Milwaukee pitching that they have shut him down up to here.
I think it's a tribute to that, and I think also, Vinny, you know, when a guy gets in a little slump sometimes, it's hard to turn it around. It's a short series.
And Gorman Thomas, for instance, had been in quite a slump, and he showed signs of coming out of it last night with a single and then losing a two-run home run. There is Keith Hernandez, one out, Obergfeld at second. No score, the Cardinals threatening here in the first inning. Haas out of a stretch and delivers in the pitch high, ball one. Sparky, a lot of pitchers lose something going from the windup to the stretch. A considerable fall off on the fastball, for instance. What about Haas?
I think Haas does. I think Haas has a much better fastball from the windup. He loses a little bit from the stretch.
One ball and no strikes, the count to Keith Hernandez. Haas again out of a stretch. Another look down the barrel at Ted Simmons, and the right-hander works the plate, and he's low. Ball two.
I know a thing right now that Whitey will really be interested in. He wanted to get him into a stretch and find out early, and Haas you can run on. He takes a long time going to the plate, Ben.
Well, you can sure that Whitey will hold up the X-ray to the light then and watch him. 2-0 to Keith Hernandez with George Hendrick in the on-deck circle. just the start of the ball game. So pull up a chair and spend part of Saturday with us. Here's the 2-0 pitch on the way. Fastball just outside. Ball three. Do you have any trouble with the sun here at County Stadium? Do the players talk about brightness or any problems?
Well, right now they won't have any trouble except the catcher. That's why Teddy came out and took a look at it. The left fielder later on, as this thing goes later on in the day, the left fielder will start getting problems with it.
3-0, the count to Keith Hernandez. Haws out of a stretch. Another look back at second. Comes back to his hitter, and they let him swing 3-0, and he fouled it away.
Vinny, later on in the day, especially, well, I don't know today, but especially around 4 o'clock, the only place that won't be under shadow will be left field.
3-1, the count to Keith Hernandez. Keisha just joined us. Tommy Herr called out on strikes. Obergfeld doubled over first base and down the line. And Hernandez up there fouled off the 3-0 pitch. And Haas ready to make the 3-1 pitch. And the right-hander deals, and that swung on and missed. Was that forkball? At least it had some drop to it.
I think that was his hard slider. His forkball normally will go dead down. I think that ball was his hard slider, and he's got a good one there.
Yeah, that's a lot of motion on that one. 3-2, the count to Keith Hernandez. The right-hand hitting George Hendrick is on deck. Hernandez pumping the wood, now quiets the bat. Haas out of a stretch, and the pitch is swung on and missed. Good fastball to blow him away. So two down, and the batter, George Hendrick, who flied to right field. The right fielder, so far in the series, has one hit and nine at-bats. So with Ken Obergfeld at second and two down in the first inning. George Hendrick checking in at the plate. Last night, he was on base three times, only once on an infield single, and they argued that. He also walked, and you might remember in the ninth inning last night, Hendrick reached first on catcher's interference. Haas ready, delivers, and a pitch fouled away, and another good fastball, so it looks like he has certainly brought a good fastball to the game.
And it looks like Teddy Simmons is establishing that early. He's going to establish with moves that he's got a good fastball. Let's establish that first, and then later on as we go, we'll start mixing some other stuff in there.
0-1, the count of George Hendrick. Moose Haas struck out Herr and Hernandez. Obergfeld taking a pretty good lead at second base. The infield a normal depth. The outfield about straight away on Hendrick, who can use the whole field. The strike one pitch. He looks at a strike on the outside corner. So we've seen a good fastball, a hard slider, and we're still kind of looking for that split-fingered pitch. 0-2. Chuck Hiller coaching at third for the Cardinals. Hal Lanier over at first. Haas born in Baltimore. Makes his home in Hampstead, Maryland. Moose checking and the crowd trying to exhort him to maybe punch out the lights of George Hendrick. And the strike two pitch to the right fielder is a high chopper over the mound. Tough play for Yount. He can't short hop it. The ball kicks out onto the grass in right field, and Obergfeld will score. That was a tough play. Robin Yount had one of those do-or-die plays trying to short hop it on the dead run, and he couldn't do it. So Hendrick gets a scratch single off Yount's glove, and Obergfeld comes home. And the Cardinals are out in front 1-0. That looked like it was hit on AstroTurf, Sparky. It took such a high bounce once it hit the ground in front of home plate.
There's no question in my mind that this field is very close to the St. Louis field. Very hard infield.
So a run in for the Birds. Hendrick standing at first and Darryl Porter the hitter. Porter hitting 364 with two RBIs. Remember the wrong field double he had against Don Sutton. Haas out of a stretch, looks at Hendrick, works Porter in the dirt, and a short hop nicely by Ted Simmons, ball one. Hendrick is not a base stealer, yet last night they turned him loose in the fourth inning, and he was thrown out by plenty. And he was thrown out with two out and Darryl Porter at the plate. We'll see if they're thinking about that again. Hendrick taking a short lead. He only stole three bases during the regular year. The 1-0 pitch, high and outside, ball two. 2-0. Darryl Porter with Lonnie Smith on deck. Here in the inning, Herr struck out. Obergfeld doubled to right. Hernandez struck out. But Hendrick, an infield single, and kicked off Robin Yount's glove. And Obergfeld, running with two outs, scored easily. Throw to first just to keep Hendrick back to the bag. Cooper, Gantner, Yount, and Molitor. Ogilvy, Thomas, and Moore in the outfield. Simmons behind the plate. And right-hander Moose Hawes on the hill. The 2-0 pitch on the way, and Porter strokes it in the air and loops it into center for a base hit. Hendricks stopping at second base as Gorman Thomas brings it in. So Porter didn't hit it hard, kind of a dunker off the end of the bat, but he'll take it. That's the third Cardinal hit in the first inning, and the batter is Lonnie Smith. 1-0 in favor of St. Louis. Lonnie Smith followed by Dane Orge. Dave Phillips, the plate umpire, summoning the ball boy. So timeout just for the moment. Lonnie Smith hitting .364. The ball boy had to remove a large piece of plywood that was stacked up against the box seat railing. He's taking it down into the Milwaukee dugout, and now we're ready. Lonnie with four hits, and he scored twice, clinches, and takes a strike.
You talk about poor Haas out there, Vinny. He's given up a run. He had a ball go right directly over the bag. He had a high chopper go for a base hit, and now he's had one off the end of the bat. I bet you're starting to wonder, my Lord, today isn't my day.
Which would, of course, be the worst thing to think about. Just the start of the ball game, and the Cardinals have a run. 0-1 to count to Lonnie Smith. Lonnie takes outside. One ball and one strike. Do you run into that negative thinking, especially with young players, where they think it's not my day?
Oh, yes, no question about it, especially when you have balls like that falling in all over. You think, my goodness, here we are already in the first inning and nothing's going right.
The 1-1 pitch to Lonnie Smith is swung on, a chopper to third, and Molitor will walk it to the bag to get the force on Hendricks. A run on three hits, two left, and at the end of half an inning, Cardinals 1, Milwaukee coming up.
WMAQ.
If you want the health insurance that comes with Good Neighbor Service, check with State Farm. Whether you have health insurance through your employer or buy it yourself, your State Farm agent will help you determine if your coverages are really right for today's needs. And you can count on that same agent for prompt personal service. For up-to-date health insurance and Good Neighbor Service, too, check with State Farm.
And like a good neighbor,
the average car may be getting smaller, but the average American is getting taller. That's why the small, efficient Buick Skyhawk doesn't forget Buick's biggest fans. With an optional 1.8-liter engine, it offers an EPA-estimated MPG of 28. Use estimated MPG for comparisons. Actual mileage may be different. But inside, there's luxury and room for even those with above-average dimensions. The 1983 Buick Skyhawk. Like a lot of people, you'll fit right in.
Year-round live coverage of the tops in sports. You'll get it all from CBS Radio Sports. NCAA basketball, Masters golf, horse racing, baseball, tennis. No matter where you go, take sports along on radio from CBS Radio Sports. Hear it here. Left-hander Dave LaPointe, the youngster from Glens Falls, New York. 9 wins and 3 losses during the regular year. And LaPointe heating up, getting ready to pitch to Paul Molitor, then Robin Yount and Cecil Cooper. LaPointe with a good fastball and slider and an exceptional changeup. Like so many other left-handers in the league, he can really pull the string.
I found that anytime you get a left-hander that has a good changeup, he can get right-handers out probably easier than he gets left-handers out.
And I guess the greatest attention given to that changeup really was the 1955 World Series, when Johnny Podras stood out in Yankee Stadium as a kid and threw a lot of changes and got the Yankees by the neck and went on to beat them 2-0, and that's all everybody talked about, the Padres change.
Well, let me say this. If LaPointe has any change up like Padres, he'll win easy today. I don't believe he's at that point yet.
Well, Paul Molitor is going to test him out, then Robin Yount and Cecil Cooper, and we'll set the Cardinals defensively. Keith Hernandez and Tommy Herr, Ozzie Smith and Ken Obergfeld, Lonnie Smith, Willie McGee, and George Hendrick in the outfield. Molitor, who started out with 5 hits in the series, is hitting .467. 7 hits and an RBI, including 2 runs scored. So Paul will begin it. One to nothing St. Louis, and Dave LaPointe trying to beat his old buddies. And the left-hander delivers, and the first pitch, a ground ball to third. Obergfeld is up with it and throws out Molitor. Do you mind, in the very first inning, the leadoff hitter hitting the first pitch? I mean, does that bother you at all?
No, Vinny, especially a club like Milwaukee. They, if you noticed last night, they were losing by 5 runs, and they had 2 men on, 1 out, 3-1, and they were still swinging. That's the way they play. They're not going to change because of the World Series.
And, of course, they do know the left-handed Dave LaPointe since he was with the Brewers, so it's not a case of finding out what kind of stuff he has. Here's Robin Yount. He takes high, ball one. Robin hitting .385. He has 5 hits during the series, 3 RBIs. He's also scored 3 runs. Yount right in hitting shortstop. The fastball runs away high and outside. 2-0 the count. Robin coming off a great year, hitting .331. He had 29 home runs and 114 runs batted in. He only missed a half a dozen games all year. The 2-0 pitch. Robin takes outside. Ball three. 3-0. So Dave LaPointe, charged with a big responsibility, although the pressure less in this game for him than just about any other game he could pitch. Here's the 3-0 pitch on the way, and that's down the pipe. 3-1. The point being, if LaPointe loses, okay, now they're even again. If he wins, then the Brewers would have their backs to the walls. Dave looks in, now to the windup. The big left-handed delivers, and a fastball fouled away. That'll carry to the second deck, rattle around, and drop down below. Last night, the paid attendance, a whopper, 56,556. And you have to believe there would be that many here again today. 3-2, the count to Robin Yount. And here comes LaPointe. The left-hander's fastball is hit slowly to third. Obergefell barehands it and drops it. And Yount's aboard.
You know, Benny, it wouldn't have mattered there if he'd have fielded that ball. You could never get Yount. He was moving out of the box on the swing. He was fooled a little bit. He was already going towards first.
And Obergefell, with 2 strikes on him, was playing very deep. So Yount gets an infield single and a high chopper, and that will bring up Cecil Cooper. A question. Cooper hang in well against left-handers, or does he bail out? Does he give?
No, he won't move at all. Left-handers don't bother him, although he will hit more balls to left center off of left-handers, but the ball down and in again, he'll still pull that ball.
Cooper, of course, hit one out last night against Bruce Sutter. Cecil hitting .308 in the series. He has 4 hits, including a double and a home run and 3 RBIs. So Cooper, left-hand hitter with an open stance, and Dave LaPointe out of a stretch, looks at first, comes to Cooper very high, ball one. When you see a hitter, particularly with an open stance like Cecil, what does that tell you right away?
It tells me right away, normally he's going to step in towards the plate. Then he's open to step in because he wants to keep that shoulder closed. You have to run the ball deep on him. Go back in on him because he's stepping towards the plate.
1 ball and no strikes the count, and Darryl Porter out to the mound talking to Dave LaPointe and perhaps talking about just that point for all we know. LaPointe's earned run average was not quite 3.5, but he's a winner. Not only was he 9-3, in the 21 games that he appeared in as a starter, the Cardinals won 16 of them. So he kept them close all the time. And today he's leading 1-0 in the bottom of the first. Robin Yount at first, Cecil Cooper the hitter, and the right side of the infield is opened up. LaPointe ready, delivers, and he's low. Tommy Herr playing slightly over to his right, and with Hernandez on the bag, that's a rather inviting hole on the right side. Ron Hansen coaching at first, Harry Warner over at third. Cooper had a look at Warner to see if they let him swing, 2-0. LaPointe ready, Dave delivers. Fastball, pop foul off to the left of the plate. Porter coming over to the box seat railing, he will run out of room. Well back in. 2-1, the count to Cecil Cooper. Dave LaPointe, and a rubber wrinkle in a new ball, taking a little walk around the mound. Cecil Cooper with Ted Simmons on deck. 1-0 St. Louis in the first inning. For the Brewers, of course, you could almost label this a must-win. If they go down 3-1 and have to look at Bob Forsch tomorrow, they would be in a tough spot. The 2-1 pitch, instead of throw to first.
Then their pitcher would have to be a must game for him.
Yeah, and if we give the ball to Mike Caldwell, who pitched so well over in St. Louis. 2-1, the count to Cecil Cooper. LaPointe kicks, delivers high and inside. So he's struggling a little bit now. 3-1, the count to Cecil Cooper. 1 out, first inning, 1-0 St. Louis. Boy, what a magnificent day here in Milwaukee. Cooper back up to the plate, in that familiar crouch, open stance, bending at the knees and waist. The pitch to him is swung on and missed, 3-2. And he's the hitter. When he swings, those toes wind up pointed to the sky.
Sure do.
Koop backs out for a moment. With one out, trailing 1-0 in the first inning, what are the odds of Yount going?
They'll run Yount.
So Robin off the bag at first, held on by Hernandez. LaPointe, a look over, and he goes. And Cooper hits a line drive at her, just lobs it to Hernandez, double play. And at the end of an inning, the Cardinals won, Milwaukee nothing.
WMAQ.
Get up to $9.50 in refunds on some of the highest quality automotive products you can buy for any make of car. Save up to $4 on Motorcraft spark plugs and $1 on Motorcraft oil and air filters. Save $1.50 on 5 quarts of Motorcraft oil. Plus, get $2 in bonus refunds on qualifying purchases. See your Motorcraft retailer for details now through November 30th. Motorcraft automotive products from Ford for the future of your car. For sure.
We're going to the second inning here at County Stadium in Milwaukee with the Cardinals leading 1-0. Infield single following the double by Ken Obergfeld got the run home. It's Moose Hawes and the left-handed Dave LaPointe. Tomorrow, Mike Caldwell and Bob Forsch in Game 5 at County Stadium, and it will be a 4:35 p.m. Eastern Time ball game. Moose Hawes just about finished his warm-up tosses. And it'll be Dane Orge, the designated hitter, then Willie McGee and Ozzie Smith. Dane Orge is 2-for-6 as a designated hitter, one of them a double. So the left-hand hitter climbs in and Haas waits for him. Molitor up about even with the bag at third, everybody else in a normal depth. And if anything, the outfield shading the other way on Orge, shading him to go to left. Haas ready, delivers, fastball outside, ball one. 1-0. Charlie Moore way over in right. Gorman Thomas shading towards left center, and Ogilvie deep and straight away in left. One ball and no strikes to Dane Orge. Right-hander Haas delivers. Fastball, but again outside. And now we'll check the count. Two balls and no strikes. So Orge backs out and has a look at his third base coach, Chuck Hiller. Haas into his windup. The 2-0 pitch on the way is a fastball over for a strike. 2-1. He's just staying with the fastball right now on the count 2-1. I guess if you had to put a label on Moose Haas in the years he has been with Milwaukee, it would be inconsistent.
And basically because of his youth, he tries to nibble too much rather than to go right after you and challenge you.
2-1. The count to Dane Orge. Right-hander Haas back to the plate, and that stroke to center. Coming up for it is Gorman Thomas to make the catch for the out. One away.
I would say if Moose has had any problems over the last 2 or 3 years, it's been the fact that he hasn't taken his good fastball and said, here, hit me if you can. He's nibbled around, got himself behind, and has taken away from him using his good slider.
And I guess one of the problems that Haas had goes back 2 years ago to 1980. He won 16 games. Admittedly, he also lost 15, but he won 16. And just as soon as you win that many, everyone says, ha-ha, the natural progression, he's going to win 20. And, of course, the next year he won 11, and everybody was bitterly disappointed, and he's come back with another 11 win this year. Willie McGee takes high, ball one.
That's why that pitcher you broadcast for a long time, Billy Lowe's, was smart. He said, I don't want to win over 16, and they expect too much.
That's right. He drove people crazy with that philosophy. 1-0, the count to Willie McGee, hitting 286. hit those two home runs last night, and he has four RBIs. He takes a strike on the outside corner, 1-1.
I'll make you bet, Benny, the way they pay today, though, Billy would have been running up about 22, 23 a year.
You betcha. Willie Dean McGee, great combination of names, as we were saying last night. He's from San Francisco, and he plays center field. He has to be called Willie. The 1-1 pitch is off speed and high, ball two. And with a middle name Dean, there's no other place for him to play except St. Louis. So Willie Dean McGee. On deck, Ozzie Smith. One out, top of the second inning. Cardinals 1, Milwaukee nothing. Haas into the windup. Moose ready and comes back 2-1, and there's a big chopper over the head of Molitor going foul and down the line. 2-2, and that pitch tied up McGee, and he fought it off reasonably well. Just a youngster, he was in the minors last year, and he's still walking around in a daze as to the wonderful things that have happened to him. But as he said last night after the game, four more games or thereabouts, and I won't be a rookie anymore. 2-2 to Willie McGee. 1-0 Cardinals, second inning. Haas into the windup. Right-hander ready, delivers, swung on, and hit foul, and just foul outside of third.
That's the scary thing, Vinny, because four more games, and he won't be a rookie, and I'm always afraid 2 years from now, will they have that same feeling as a rookie?
Yeah, that's right. Will the desire suddenly slacken off? 2-2 to Willie McGee. 1-0 St. Louis. Just the start of the ballgame, really. Second inning. Bases empty. One out. Moose Haas into the windup, and his 2-2 pitch on the way is a one-hopper banged into left field. I'll tell you one thing. McGee inside it out three in a row. They kept the ball in on his hands. He hit two outside of third and then single to left.
Yeah, and they keep throwing the ball up to him. I think they're finding out that he likes that high ball a little bit.
So McGee with a base hit, and of course, Sparky, we were talking a little while ago about Haas, the fact that he might be the easiest of the Milwaukee starting pitchers to run on, and you would guess that McGee would test him. Ozzie Smith hitting left-handed climbs in. Ozzie hitting 200. He has just two hits. McGee off the bag at first, held on by Cooper. And the first pitch is high as Ozzie was around as if to bunt. That had Paul Molitor on the move. One ball and no strikes. Ozzie taking another look at Chuck Hiller. On deck is the leadoff man, Tommy Herr.
Be very surprised if he don't run on this pitch, Vin.
McGee hands on his knees, taking a pretty good lead. Haas set at the belt. McGee does not go, and the pitch taken on the corner for a strike, 1-1. They might have given McGee the go sign, and he just didn't feel ready yet.
I was very surprised there, because after ball one, with him and his speed and Haas, I thought for sure he'd run.
1-1 to count. We'll watch McGee again now as he takes his lead. Haas brings his hands together at the belt, turns, and then just lobs a throw over to Cecil Cooper. 1-1 to count to Ozzie Smith. Cardinals one run, four hits. Milwaukee no runs, one hit. And another quick throw over to first, but again, McGee hops back on the bag. But don't let the four hits for the Cardinals sound like they have been racking up Haas. Obergefell had a legitimate double. Hendrick an infield single, and Porter a blooper to center. Now McGee, a one-hopper into left field. The 1-1 pitch, Ozzie Smith takes and got a piece of a pitch and fouled it back in the count 1-2.
It's hard for me to understand with the speed. I would have to think McGee is on his own, and with the speed he has, I don't know what he's waiting for with Smith up there. Smith's been taking everything for him.
I think that Willie McGee's character, at least at this stage of his young life and in this stage of his development as a big league ball player, he's a little on the timid side. I think he said of himself during the championship series when he made a couple of big mistakes, he said, "I'm choking out here." So he might just be a little worried. He's not quite sure of Haas' move. Maybe he's even a little intimidated by the surroundings as he takes his lead. But, of course, Ozzie Smith has put himself in a hole trying to help him. And the count 1-2. McGee does not go, and Ozzie checks swing foul off third down the line, slicing back into the seats.
I tell you, Ricky Henderson at Oakland by right now would have been his second, third, and he might be challenging coming home.
1-2. McGee is not quite that kind of a player. And you know what it is? What Maury Wills used to always talk about, the fear of failure. 1-2, way outside, one-handed by Ted Simmons. He made a save on that pitch. And McGee is still standing at first, and Chuck Hiller going through the motions in the third base coaching box. McGee inching off the bag, Cooper holding a corner. They give Ozzie the hole. They don't expect him to pull. Moose Haas, and there goes McGee, and they pitch out, but there's a double grip and then a one-hop throw by Ted Simmons. So even on a pitch out, Simmons didn't come close, and then suffering further indignity, he threw the ball on a bounce. What a time for McGee to steal.
Well, 2-2, Vinny's an excellent time to steal. It was a tremendous call by Simmons pitching out there 2-2. He's taking his pitcher to 3-2 now, and it's a great call by Simmons. People don't realize that is one of the outstanding calls.
Well, McGee is at second base, 3-2 the count to Ozzie Smith with one out. Top of the second inning, Cardinals 1, Milwaukee nothing. Ozzie trying to find a hole. McGee can take a good lead off second, and the pitch fouls straight back, and it remains 3-2. Let's pause 5.
It's Jimmy Pearsall after the game on 67 WMAQ Chicago.
Three and two, the count to Ozzie Smith. Haas, right foot on the rubber. Ted Simmons wigwagging a couple of signs out to him. Now the right-hander set, looks back at McGee, works Ozzie Smith, and he's high, ball four. So Haas making a lot of pitches now with four hits and a walk, and with runners at first and second and one out, Tommy Herr will be the hitter. Herr struck out in the first inning, disputed the call by Dave Phillips. So Tommy Herr checks in. Herr hitting 1-for-8 in the series. Haas, head down, staring at his feet, puts the right one on the rubber and then backs off. Now once again, Moose deep in thought and looks into Ted Simmons. Tommy Herr with Ken Obergfell to follow. One out, Birds at first and second, and the pitch is chopped up along first base foul, and the count 0-1.
Cardinals have really made Haas do something with McGee getting on. If you watch him now, Vinny, he's just stepping and throwing. He's not bringing that leg up. Every once in a while he is, but basically he's stepping and throwing and is taking that life away from his fastball.
I'm just going to say, every time you make an adjustment, you have to pay the bill for it.
And that's what the Cardinals are doing. If you watch him now, he's just stepping and throwing.
0-1 the count. And, of course, Molitor right at the bag at third. He has to be thinking about the possibility of the Cardinals even trying a double steal. So there's a lot of heat on Haas. Moose set, looks at the runners, to the bag goes Gantner, and the pitch in the dirt gets away from Simmons, and there you have the runners going to second and third. Wild pitch charged to Moose Haas, so McGee moves over to third, Ozzie Smith goes to second, and Moose Haas is in trouble, and so are the Brewers.
Well, they just can't afford to have these kind of things happening, and there's a case where you have to keep, they're going to have to keep McGee and Smith off the base. If they don't, there's just no way to contain the Cardinals.
So second and third, one out, first base open, and the Cardinals leading 1-0. Tommy Herr struggling with the bat, hitting 083, but of course he's up there now with a chance to really hurt you. There's no one throwing in the Milwaukee bullpen. We'll see if Haas will go to a windup or a stretch, and he's going to go from a stretch. You like that idea with second and third?
I can't understand it. You got your shortstop and second base and playing deep, and he's pitching from a stretch.
Right.
It don't even make sense.
No, and they're letting him get away with it. Here's the 1-1 pitch to Tommy Herr. Fast one, low, ball two. 2-1.
The only time you ever pitch from a stretch with a man on third is when you bring your infield in. If you're going to play your infield back, you pitch from a windup. It's only common sense. He has more strength from a windup, or he pitched from a stretch all the time.
Well, you have all that brains down there in the Milwaukee dugout just staring out at him. And once again, Haas pitching from a stretch with runners at second and third. Moose at the belt. And the 2-1 pitch, Tommy Herr fouls it away in the count 2-2. Naturally, the old answer you always get if you ask about that, say, well, it helps his control.
It helps his control, then why don't he pitch that way all the time? Suter pitches that way all the time, Benny. That's because it helps his control. This young man is pitching from a windup with nobody on, a stretch with men on.
2-2, the count to Tommy Herr. 1-0 St. Louis here in the second inning, and the Cardinals with a golden opportunity to fly away to a 3-0 lead. Willie McGee down the line from third. Ozzie Smith away from second. And Tommy Herr trying to get a piece of the ball, 2-2. Again, Haas out of a stretch. Set at the belt. And the 2-2 pitch to Herr is swung on, and a foul ball down the left field line, slicing back into the seats out of play.
You know what's happened so far, Minnie, especially in the last three ball games is just a case of little things. The Cardinals are doing a lot of little things. Milwaukee hasn't been doing the little things, and it's killing them.
One run, four hits for the Cardinals. No runs, one hit for Milwaukee. Here in the inning, Willie McGee single a left with one out, stole second. Ozzie Smith walked, and then they each moved up 90 feet on a wild pitch. And with one out, two and two, the count to Tommy Herr. Haas taking a lot of time. Now Moose is set. Looks at second, comes to his hitter, and it swung on and hit foul down to Hal Lanier. So it's still two and two. Lanier, pretty good infielder in his playing days. So Tommy Herr with a short stroke trying to keep the inning alive and pick up a runner or two along the way. Ken Obergfell, a left-hand hitter on deck. Haas picked up two strikeouts in the first inning. He got Herr and Hernandez, but he was a victim of some tough luck on the infield single by Hendrick that got the run home. 2-2 pitch. Herr has to get out of there and drop to his right knee. Almost took that thing at the chin, looking for a pitch away, and Haas came in on him. So 3-2, the count to Tommy Herr. Herr backs out, thinking over what he figures to get. And if you're the hitter, I guess you got to look at fastball now, right?
I think he's got to make sure he hits the ball, Ben. He's just going to try to put it in play. He'll score a run if he hits a ground ball to short a second.
The infield is back. Cooper and Molitor have shortened up, however. The 3-2 pitch is swung on and a high fly ball to center. Gorman Thomas came in. Now he has to go way back to the track and one-handed, and then he fell down. McGee scores, and here coming to the plate trying to score is Ozzie Smith, and he does. They get two on a long fly ball to center when Gorman Thomas caught it and fell down. And Gorman was fooled on that fly ball from the moment it left the bat.
Yeah, Benny, and we'll go back right to the things. You look, they picked up two runs this inning and a run last inning that really they haven't done anything, and they've been able to score three runs. It's just been little things. They've had a stolen base, a ball getaway, a fly ball, and now they've got two more runs.
The fly ball by Tommy Herr and a 3-2 fastball. He hit it about 385 feet, and Gorman Thomas caught it and then lost his footing on the track and fell down. McGee came in easily, and then Ozzie Smith, wide open, scored from second, and it is 3-0 Cardinals. Two out, and here is Ken Obergfell. Oh, and the pitch inside, so strange developments here. One ball and no strikes to Ken Obergfell. The last things the Brewers needed, of course, in this series was to fall behind and early. The 1-0 pitch is inside at the hands, ball two, 2-0. So McGee singled and stole second despite a pitch-out call by Ted Simmons. Ozzie Smith walked. A wild pitch moved them to second and third. And Herr's long fly ball, caught by Thomas, is good for two runs. Now the 2-0 pitch, that's low, ball three, 3-0. Moose Haas has now made 50 pitches, and we have two out in the second inning. You just can't be around too long making that many.
You ain't going to stay around long, because if you do, you're going to have to throw over 200 pitches.
3-0 the count. Haas ready and delivers, and he's high with it, ball four. And this crowd bordering on being disgusted right now. That's the second walk in the inning. And Keith Hernandez coming up. Still no one throwing, but in a moment they're going to get somebody up down in the Milwaukee bullpen. Haas struggling in the first two innings, more because he's unlucky than anything else. The first man to move around down in the bullpen is Jim Slayton. And the first pitch to Hernandez misses, ball one, and so Ted Simmons goes out to the mound. 1-0 the count. Simmons, Thomas, and Ogilvy are due up when the Brewers come up in the bottom of the second inning. Cardinals 3, Milwaukee nothing, but you'd have to see it to believe it.
Well, you'd have to do that, Benny, but that's what I've always said. You can have all the power and thunder in the world, but it's the little things that are still going to end up winning ballgames.
So Moose Haas has given up a couple of walks and a single. And he's down 3-0. The runner goes. The pitch is low. The throw is way offline. Sparky, I don't mean to put the rap on Ted Simmons, but it looks like he can't throw at all.
Well, he's having some problems getting rid of the ball, too, getting it out of his mitt, Vinny. He's not that bad of a thrower. the Cardinals, he had a great jump over Fell. And
I don't mean the jumps, but I just mean the throw. There's nothing on it, and he's way offline.
Yeah, I think he's really pressing now, too. They're going to force it.
2-0, the count to Keith Hernandez with Ken Obergfell at second base, the second stolen base in the inning. Hernandez still looking for a hit. He struck out in the first inning. He's 0-for-12, and he takes low and outside, ball three. So the Moose is going to be above the fireplace any minute now.
Getting a little, yelling a little bit and starting to get a little impatient.
3-0 the count. Hernandez, remember they let him swing 3-0 last at bat. There he goes again, a sharp ground ball to Gantner and right through his legs. In comes Obergfell. Hernandez on his way to second base, beats the throw from Charlie Moore. It is 4-0 St. Louis, and the beer has gone flat in Milwaukee.
See, that's what happens when you start playing some bad baseball and start having little things happen against you. Pretty soon the whole thing breaks open.
So they let Keith swing 3-0, and Gantner backed up trying to get the ball on a favorable hop. And, of course, the old story, once you let the ball play you, you're in a lot of trouble. And it went right through Gantner's legs. 4-0 in favor of the St. Louis Cardinals. And the batter now is George Hendrick. Four runs, four hits, no errors for the Cardinals. No runs, one hit, one error for Milwaukee. And Hendrick takes a strike, 0-1. For Milwaukee, by the way, they have now made five errors in three games plus two innings. 0-1 to Hendrick. George had that high chopping single to shortstop and picked up an RBI in the first inning. This time he swings and fouls it back. And the count 0-2.
I think, too, Vinny, that speed of the Cardinals has really started to get to their minds. They know now that every time they get one on, they're going to let him go.
Oh, yes. 0-2 the count. We mentioned at the very start of the series that perhaps one of the big shocks, seeing the two best teams in their leagues going head-to-head, how poor the catchers throw. The strike two pitch on the way, and Hendrick hits it off the hands, a little slicing foul ball. Back of first, down the line, Cooper makes the catch. But it's the Cardinals who made the big catch, a three-run second inning. And at the end of an inning and a half, Cardinals 4, Milwaukee nothing.
WMAQ.
Want some excellent advice from IBM? Invest in bronze. Why bronze? Because IBM offers lower prices on almost every standard IBM Selectric and electronic typewriter in this color. So, if you're thinking about buying a new typewriter, now you can save on most IBM typewriters just by letting IBM color your choice. The handsome bronze color is available on IBM Correcting Selectric 3 typewriters, the typewriters that lift mistakes clean off the page, as well as IBM electronic typewriters. For more information, call IBM direct, toll-free, at 1-800-631-5582. That's 1-800-631-5582. And if you're looking for a solid investment in quality and productivity, take a tip from IBM. Buy bronze. It's as good as gold.
Another fantastic event in space scheduled for November 11th, the fifth flight of the space shuttle Columbia, and the first time four Americans will be launched into space at once. CBS News covers the launch, spacewalk, and landing in special reports. Scheduled start November 11th. Hear it here. Well, the Cardinals have been launched. They're leading 4-0, and the Brewers, a ball club that has come back time and time again, has now been asked to come back again. And they had better get a move on against left-hander Dave LaPointe. He gave up an infield single to Robin Yount in the first inning. Ted Simmons, who certainly has some added incentive now after they ran him a bit, he'll be followed by Gorman Thomas and then Ben Ogilvy. Simmons hitting right-handed. If you had your druthers, would you rather pitch to Simmons left-handed or right-handed?
Much rather pitch to him right-handed. He's a high ball hitter right-handed. He loves the fastball, but he's a much, much better hitter left-handed.
So here is Simmons starting it off, and left-handed Dave LaPointe looks in to get a sign. LaPointe, a big kid at 6'3", delivers high, ball 1-0. He went to school in Glen Falls, New York, and lettered in baseball and football. There's nothing new about that, but he also lettered in bowling. The 1-0 pitch high, ball 2.
That's not bad. You wouldn't think he'd be bowling too much if he was a pitcher.
Right. I was just going to bring that point up. It is just totally against the arm to pitch and very natural to bowl. The left-hander into the windup, and the 2-0 pitch on the way is a ground foul outside of third and down the line, and the count 2-1 to Ted Simmons. Do you have rules about your players? If you're a pitcher, you shouldn't play golf, or you shouldn't bowl, or...
No, I let them play golf when they pitch. Like, if they pitch today, they can play golf tomorrow.
2-1 pitch to Ted Simmons on the inside corner for a strike, and the count 2-2. David Jeffrey LaPointe. Only 23 years old. It looks like the Cardinals have really found themselves quite a talented kid. The 2-2 pitch to Simmons, waved at and missed. And down he goes. And that was that great change that the kid has. We talked about at the start of the game.
He looks like Vinny on that change of his, too, that he kind of, at the last minute, kind of turns it over a little.
He has, if you were going to star one of his pitches as outstanding, it would be that changeup. And Ted Simmons totally fooled on it. So one away, and the batter now is Gorman Thomas, hitting 182, and much to his embarrassment, first getting a bad jump on the long fly ball, and then for good measure, after catching it, he fell down, and it meant the additional run. And the pitch to Gorman is lifted into left center field, moving in and over is Lonnie Smith, Ozzie Smith, and Willie McGee, and it's McGee making the catch. So a trio of Cardinals going after that fly ball, and the center fielder takes charge. Ben Ogilvie will be the batter. Ogilvie hitting 083. In fact, going into the game, Cooper was hitting over 300, and Molitor, Charlie Moore. But Ogilvie tied up in knots. Ben, the left-hand hitter, waiting at the plate. Just one hit. He scored a run, and he takes a strike in the count 0-1. The Cardinals 4, Milwaukee nothing, bottom of the second inning. Dave LaPointe looks down to get a sign from Darryl Porter. The left-hander ready in the strike one pitch, and that's high and inside. One ball, one strike. I was just thinking, isn't it amazing about this game? It is the Brewers who are falling down and making the errors. And remember that 10-0 game, the first game of the series, they looked like they couldn't do anything wrong. The 1-1 pitch on the way, and it's driven to deep left center field. Lonnie Smith to the warning track at the wall. Can't get it. It's off the wall. Willie McGee will retrieve. Ogilvie is on his way to third. He's in there standing with a triple. Lonnie Smith going up against the left field wall. Lonnie is not an outstanding defensive outfielder, and you certainly get the feeling that several National League left fielders would have caught the ball, but Lonnie did not, which is the important thing, and Ben Ogilvie is at third. So with two out, a slight break now for Milwaukee to get on the scoreboard, and Don Money the batter. Money, the designated hitter, is 1-for-3 in that role. LaPointe into the windup and delivers, and it's in the dirt, pushed out in front of the plate by Darryl Porter. 0-1. Don Money had a base hit in the ninth inning of the first game in that 10-0 Milwaukee rout of St. Louis. 1-0 the count to Don. Ogilvie walking down the line from third. The outfield playing Money deep and way around the left. The 1-0 pitch on the way is swung on and beaten foul back to the screen. And the count, one ball, one strike. Money during the regular year at 16 home runs, 55 RBIs, and a .284 average. Money waiting, trying to pick up Ogilvie. Dave LaPointe into the windup, and the 1-1 pitch swung on and missed. Good breaking ball down and in, 1-2. Don Money has played in over 1,000 games as a Brewer. Don waiting, and the 1-2 pitch coming up. LaPointe bounces it in front of the plate, and again blocked by Darryl Porter. Interestingly enough, Don Money had a book out, but it wasn't about himself. He wrote a book about Henry Aaron's first year as a Brewer. The title of the book was The Man Who Made Milwaukee Famous. 2-2, the count to Don Money, who is trying to author an RBI right now, and he swings and rolls it foul outside of third and down the line. money, an American League All-Star four different times. He was also the Brewers MVP a couple of times. He's had a great career. He started with Philadelphia way back in 1968 and came to Milwaukee in 73. The pitch to Don Money is chased and missed, and down he goes. And LaPointe has fooled another, and they leave Ogilvy. And at the end of two, Cardinals four, Milwaukee nothing.
Talk baseball with Pearsall after the game on WMAQ.
Before winter weather stops your car cold, True Value Hardware Stores want to offer a winter driving tip. Hi, Pat Summerall suggesting you replace your old spark plugs now with new Champion Copper Plus spark plugs. They'll give more than twice the fouling protection of other major brands to help prevent stalling, misfiring, or bad starts. In a cold weather test against another major brand, Champion Copper Plus spark plugs continued to fire and start long after the others had fouled and stopped. And you'll find them at participating True Value hardware stores and home centers.
How you doing, everybody? This is Chet Kopic of Channel 5 Sports. Coming up at 10 p.m. tonight on our Channel 5 News. It's a big day for sports. We'll have complete World Series highlights. St. Louis Cardinals versus Milwaukee Brewers. We'll also update all those college football scores. Keep you posted on the Chicago Bulls and the Chicago Blackhawks. Don't forget, for the action, highlights, interviews, Sports 5 is the place you want to be. See you tonight at 10 p.m. on Chicago's Channel 5 News.
WMAQ.
Say, friends, if you're on the go this weekend, there's no need to miss baseball's main event. Take a radio along to keep up with all the World Series action. Wherever you're going to be, why, take us along, too. Sparky Anderson, Win Elliott, and yours truly, Vin Scully. The 1982 World Series, something special from CBS Radio. This broadcast is presented by authority of Major League Baseball and is intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the descriptions and accounts of this game without the express written consent of Major League Baseball is prohibited. Moose Haas goes back to work with the Brewers down 4-0. And for the Cardinals, Darryl Porter, followed by Lonnie Smith, and then Dane Orge. In that second inning, we saw Jim Slayton warm up. But eventually, the last out, the foul ball to Cecil Cooper, and so Haas hangs in there, having made 58 pitches. But to compare him with Dave LaPointe, Haas has made 58, and LaPointe has made only 28. Porter, one for one. He singled to center, takes a strike, 0-1. Darryl hitting one off the end of the bat and looped it to center field. Four runs, four hits for the Cardinals. And Porter bringing a .417 average up to the plate in this series. He has five hits, and he takes high. Of course, Paul Molitor, with a five-hit game, has the most hits of anyone in the series. Molitor has seven. Robin Yount has six. The 1-1 pitch to Darryl Porter. He has a look, and he'll pay a price for it. It's on the outside corner for a strike, even though he doesn't believe it. He looks at Dave Phillips and cocks his head, but that's it. 1-2 the count to Darryl Porter. Top of the third inning, and it's been all St. Louis thus far. 4-0 Cardinals, trying to take a 3-1 lead in this best 4 out of 7. Now the 1-2 pitch to Darryl Porter, half swing, and he fouled it away, so it's still 1-2. Sparky, did you see that quote in the paper attributed to Whitey Herzog? He was saying a championship series should be like the World Series and be best 4 out of 7.
Yeah, I've seen that, Vinny, and, you know, I'm not too sure he's not right. I think the reason he means that is that when you're going to hook up two clubs to go into a World Series, give them the opportunity, they might have a bad game. And by going 4 out of 7, there's a much better chance you're going to have the best club.
1-2, the count to Darryl Porter. Right-hander Haas delivers, and that's hit halfway back to the mound. Haas down to pick it up, straightens up, and throws him out. One away. So Porter hits back to the box, and that'll bring up Lonnie Smith, who hit into a force play in the first inning. Lonnie 0-for-1. Of course, the problem with baseball, with all the games you have, you still have the same year. It's not a rubberized year, which means if the playoffs run into any rain and you start saying 4 out of 7, and then you get into the World Series, you're looking into November.
Well, play up to Christmas.
Lonnie Smith, right hand hitting left fielder, takes low and inside, ball one. Lonnie with two hits in the series, hitting .167. Hit over .300 during the regular year, but then he cooled off in September, and he hasn't really regained his stroke in the series. The 1-0 pitch on the way, a check swing, a little soft line drive right to Haas. And the line drive was not that it was hit hard, just the trajectory of it. went straight at Moose Hawes. So two down, and Dane Orge will be coming up. When the Brewers bat in the third, they'll have Charlie Moore, followed by Jim Gantner, and then Paul Molitor. Orge, a left-hand hitter, DH. And Moose Hawes waiting for him. Now the right-hander into the windup. Hawes comes to the plate. Good fastball. Over for a strike. Cardinals got a double by Obergfell and an infield single by Hendrick that went off Robin Yount's glove, allowing Obergfell to score. The second inning, the Cardinals scored two on a scoring fly ball to center and another on an error. 1-1 now, the count to Dane Orge. With any kind of a break, a good break, the Brewers would be down 1-0.
At the most, 1-0. Could be nothing.
Here's the 1-1 pitch on the way, and Dane Orge takes on the outside corner for a strike, 1-2. And that is from, I guess, as neutral an observer as you can get. I mean, you and I have no access to grind either way.
We're not going to get anything no matter who wins, man. No. I know. I found that out a long time ago.
Yeah, our names never came up when they talked about full shares. 1-2, the count of Dane Orge. Right-hander Haas delivers on the hands. Good fastball fouled away off to the left. So Dane Orge still there. One ball, two strikes.
You know, Benny, I'll never forget. I had a manager 2 years, Clay Bryant, who you know very well.
Yeah.
And Clay used to always say his one meeting was this. The big things will take care of themselves. You can't stop that. The little things, if you don't do it, you're not.
.392 and .402 to straightaway center. 1-2, the count to Dane Orge. Willie McGee on deck. And right-hander delivers, and that's popped in the air back a short. Yount going out to get it. He's just about there and makes the catch. And at the end of 2.5 innings, the Cardinals 4, Milwaukee nothing.
WMAQ.
I was getting my hair cut, and the stories going around the barbershop kept getting taller as my hair got shorter. So I told a true story about a Honda Accord four-door sedan. Went like this. A fella bought one and took it for a shakedown run. Well, the Honda Accord rode so smoothly that he relaxed in the plush seats, set the cruise control that comes standard, and enjoyed the scenery quietly passing by. When he returned, he went to open the trunk and found his wallet lying on the Accord's rear bumper. He'd put it there while loading the trunk and had forgotten it. That should give you an idea about the smooth ride a Honda Accord four-door sedan can deliver, I said. Well, the barber shook his head. I swore the story was true, because it is. I got up to pay for my haircut, and I found I had misplaced my wallet again.
Honda, we make it simple. Be all that you can be.
You do get a sense of pride being served.
Army Reservist Karen Gorey.
You always have a sense of pride, I guess, because after going through basic, after going through your schooling, then getting back to your unit, and you're going, whew, I finally made it. I get a good feeling because I know I've done it. And no one on the can ever change that feeling.
If you'd like to earn a nice extra income one weekend a month, call your Army Reserve recruiter today.
Because we need you.
Paid for by the Army Reserve.
In the Army Reserve.
Bottom of the third inning here at County Stadium, Milwaukee. The St. Louis Cardinals leading the Brewers 4-0. It'll be Charlie Moore, followed by Jim Gantner, and then Paul Molitor. Charlie Moore, the scrappy right fielder, making his first at-bat. Charlie is 4-for-12 in the series. He has two doubles and a run batted in. So the chant is here, go Brewers go, if not quite the intensity and the emotion, but the fans trying to stir themselves in their ball club. And the pitch to Charlie Moore, a strike, 0-1. Dave LaPointe, who pitched here in Milwaukee in 1980, coming back to haunt them. In 1980, he was 1-0. The pitch swung on by Moore, and a high fly ball to right center. It's playable, and Willie McGee says he'll take it, and he does. Just held up his hand and told Hendrick, don't bother. So Charlie Moore, a fly ball, one away. Jim Gantner coming up. Gantner, 4-for-10 in the series, a .400 batting average, including a double and a triple, and two runs batted in. Gantner committing an error in the second inning, his second error of the series, and he hits one slowly to third. Obergefell picks it up over to first in time, and LaPointe getting his point home to Milwaukee now, retiring the first two batters very easily in the third inning. And Paul Molitor coming up. 4-0 St. Louis. Molitor grounded to third in the first inning. Paul is 0-1. Sun-drenched County Stadium in Milwaukee. A light breeze blowing from left to right. Cardinals scoring a run in the first inning and three in the second. Molitor climbs in. Dave LaPointe hands it his size. Now the left-hander ready, kicks and delivers, and the fastball in there. He is getting pretty consistent on getting that strike to the hitters.
Getting very confident, too, Vinny. Those four runs have made him just very confident out there.
Now the strike one pitch on the way. Runs away outside, one ball and one strike. We're talking about the fact that LaPointe is a winner. 9-3, and in the games he started, the Cardinals were 16-5. He was also very good on the road. The 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed. Games he started on the road, the Cardinals were 10-2. And all of that at 23. LaPointe working on Molitor. Dave ready, but Molitor is not and backs out. Time called by Dave Phillips. Boy, I tell you, Phillips did something no, I would not advise any umpire to do. He not only called time, but then he walked out in front of the catcher, as if to say, don't throw. The pitch is chased and missed. Molitor going after one in the dirt, and another great change by LaPointe. And at the end of three, Cardinals 4 and Milwaukee nothing.
WMAQ. Mr. Ballone?
Yes, but...
Pearl's party planning. We got your order for petunias, orchids, assorted violins.
That's assorted violets.
Oh. Hold the violins, fellas. Pearl has terrible handwriting.
Well, these flowers were for my wedding reception.
So?
That was 2 weeks ago.
Well, it's our delivery truck. Broke down. Just got a fix. Sign here, please.
Hey, don't you know about Jartran?
Sure. Hey, Ralph, got any more of those night-blooming Jartrans back there?
No. Jartran Truck Rental. Oh. It's a company that rents trucks and trailers and vans just the right size for your needs.
What do you want these garden hoses?
I asked for roses, not hoses.
Boy, Pearl has terrible handwriting.
Well, she won't have a business if she doesn't find out about Jartran Truck Rental.
You know, Jartran makes sense in today's economy. We can rent trucks just for our busy season. That month when everybody gets married?
June.
No, Pearl. Pearl's party planning.
Oh, brother.
Hey, what should I do with these musicians I brought over?
I didn't order musicians.
You sure did. Look right here, an assortment of jasmine.
That's jasmine. It's a flower.
I gotta talk to Pearl about...
For a limited time, any Jartran truck is just $29.90 a day for local rentals, Monday through Thursday. Restrictions apply, so ask for details.
So, my son who never calls finally invites his mother over for dinner.
Yeah, look in my new microwave oven, Mom.
We're having raw chicken.
Raw chicken? Where's that instruction booklet?
Donald.
Did I push the raw chicken button?
Donald.
Huh?
Call me when you get a quasar.
What Donald needs is a Quasar Instamatic microwave oven. You don't guess at power settings, times, and temperatures. You just press a button. Quasar's made microwave cooking simple.
Quasar!
For quality and dependability, shouldn't you have a Quasar?
We're going to the fourth inning at County Stadium in Milwaukee. The St. Louis Cardinals leading the Brewers and Moose Haws 4-0. For the Cardinals, Willie McGee will start it off. He'll be followed by Ozzie Smith and then Tommy Herr. Willie McGee, single to left field in the second inning, 1-1.
You know, Benny, you talk about that big trade that Milwaukee and the Cardinals have. When you look back in about 2 years or look ahead in 2 years, that LaPointe and Green, you watch, that's going to just be a standout in that trade.
Yeah, and of course, the names of Fingers and Vukovich and Simmons might very well, in 2 years, almost pass away into obscurity, and these kids are just starting. The pitch to McGee outside, ball one, 1-0. Of course, Harry Dalton in Milwaukee felt they had to win this year. So even though they might be hurt giving up young players, they did reach their objective. They did win. 2-0 the count. McGee singled in the second inning, stole second, and eventually worked his way around to score on that two-run scoring fly ball. Remember? Ozzie Smith scored when Gorman Thomas fell down. The pitch to Willie McGee on the inside corner for a strike. 2-1. Tell you what, if you're a veteran ball player like a George Hendrick, you have to look around you a little bit and say, wait a minute now, they got McGee in center, Lonnie Smith in left, and David Green at 21 chafing at the bit. There's a one-hopper to Robin Yount. It picks it up and throws out McGee. One down.
You know, Vinny, he hit a bullet directly at Yount, and I'm telling you, he didn't throw him out but about 6-8 feet.
One away. McGee, a one-hopper to Robin Yount. And Ozzie Smith coming up. Walked in the second inning. Ozzie, a switch hitter, batting left-handed. He had walked and taken second on the wild pitch and then came all the way home on that fly ball to center field. Ozzie waiting. Moose Haas into the windup. Smith bunts up along third, charging at his Molitor and throws poorly, pulling Cooper off the bag. And Molitor did something I would not imagine he would do during the year. He got a reasonably good bunt on a reasonably good bounce, and he grabbed it with two hands.
Yeah, instead of just taking with the bare hand and throwing, he got his glove involved in there.
Right, and made a poor throw to first. So Molitor doing what you don't usually see, a two-handed pickup on that bunt, and it cost him. So Ozzie Smith, a bunt single, and the batter will be Tommy Herr. Four runs, five hits for the Cardinals, and look out. They'll probably turn Ozzie Smith loose. I'll bet you Ted Simmons is thinking about it. Ozzie taking a good lead and then retreats because Haas gets off the rubber. Now Moose plants the right foot, and Ozzie Smith takes that lead, held on by Cecil Cooper. Molitor playing on the grass against Herr, who was 0 for 1. Herr struck out and then hit that 385-foot fly ball to center that meant two RBIs. Ozzie, a big lead over there at first. I'm surprised Haas hasn't driven him back, and he does. You just can't let him take that lead.
No, you get that kind of lead, he's telling you, I'm going.
Yeah. I don't believe you could ever pick me off. He has retreated. He's not quite as big, but almost. Just about got into his spike marks from the first lead. And Tommy Herr waiting. The first pitch outside. Ball one. 1-0. Cardinals scored a run in the first inning and three in the second. They have four runs on five hits. Milwaukee, no runs, two hits. A triple by Ogilvy and an infield single by Robin Yount. Ozzie Smith again off the bag and increasing the lead a little. Haas set at the belt. He doesn't go, and the pitch to the plate finds the outside corner for a strike, and the count 1-1. Tomorrow, Mike Caldwell and Bob Forsch in Game 5 of the 1982 World Series. And a reminder, that will start 4:35 p.m. Eastern Time. One and one to Tommy Herr, switch hitter, batting left-handed. Ozzie doesn't go on a fake, and there's a fly ball to center field. Thomas picks it off, waits, and makes the catch for the out. And Ozzie Smith goes back to first. So Tommy Herr, fly ball to center field. That'll bring up Ken Obergefell. Obergefell doubled to right, directly over first base and down the line, and they picked him up on the infield single by Hendrick. Then last time up, Ken walked and scored on the error charged to Jim Gantner. So Obergefell one for one, scored twice. And Ozzie Smith at first, the pitch to Obergefell outside. Ball one, 1-0. Ozzie on that last pitch did not have the same big lead that he had on previous pitches, so we'll watch him. Ozzie now just about as far off the bag as he's been allowed to get. Haas set and goes over there, and once again, Ozzie has to dive back head first and reach out with a hand. 1-0 the count. Haas head down as he puts his right foot on the rubber, deep in thought. Now looks in and decides he better go over to first again, and that was very close.
And he was going. Did you see him? He was leaning towards second. Here's where Roger Craig, our pitching coach, he throws over for that reason. Now, he would definitely pitch out on this pitch because he was leaning.
One ball and no strikes the count. So we'll see if Simmons calls a pitch out 1-0. He called it 2-2 earlier. Ozzie Smith off the bag. Haas looks in to get a sign. And Ken Obergefell waiting. Another throw, and Ozzie Smith stumbles and is picked off. Ozzie did not get back cleanly, stumbled and couldn't get there. And they pick him off 1-3. And at the end of 3.5 innings, Cardinals 4, Milwaukee nothing.
WMAQ.
My music store really had the blues. I didn't know how many drums I had in stock. And I had 500 more clarinets than I could sell. Instead of ordering banjos, I ordered ukuleles. I don't even sell ukuleles.
And
And don't ask me about my tubas. My inventory was a disaster. Now, I heard that IBM made small computers for small businesses like mine. So I bought a small IBM computer for my inventory, and now I know what to order, when to order, and how much to order. And these days, my music store is working in total harmony. But best of all, IBM sold so many different kinds of small computers that I told my brother to buy one for his business.
For more information, call IBM toll-free at 1-800-631-5582. That's 1-800-631-5582.
For 80 years, Buick has had a love affair with the automobile, right down to today's state-of-the-art Century. With its very efficient form, it offers an EPA estimated MPG of 24. Use estimated MPG for comparisons. Actual mileage may be different. And in the best Buick tradition, Century has a remarkably luxurious passenger environment. 80 years of Buick went into the 83 Century. You see, Buick's love affair with the automobile isn't getting older. It's getting better.
Bottom of the fourth inning here at County Stadium in Milwaukee. The Cardinals leading 4-0, and the Brewers trying to stir themselves. And they have the stirrers, Robin Yount, Cecil Cooper, and Ted Simmons. We'll also duck in some college football scores for you. Connecticut 7, Holy Cross nothing at the half. Clemson 28, Duke 14 at the half. Maryland 10, Wake Forest 7 in the second quarter. Georgia 7, Vanderbilt 6 in the second. Penn State 14, Syracuse nothing in the second. Yale 17, Columbia 3 in the second. Iowa, Michigan scoreless in the first. And the pitch to Robin Yount, a comebacker that gets off the glove of the point, but he picks it up and throws him out. So Yount has gone on one pitch, one away. Princeton 14, Army 10 in the second quarter. North Carolina 17, North Carolina State 2 at the half. Temple, Pittsburgh scoreless in the second quarter. One away, and LaPointe now has retired the last five in a row. And had Lonnie Smith been able to catch Ogilvy, he would really be on a string. Cecil Cooper hit into a double play in the first inning. With a runner going, Yount hit a line drive at Tommy Herr, and it was easy to just flip the ball over to Hernandez. LaPointe delivers, and the first one is low, ball one, 1-0. Dave LaPointe looks in to get a sign from Darryl Porter. And back he comes, and it's hit off the end of the stick in the hole at short. Ozzie picks it up, and that's about all he can do with it. So Cecil Cooper, a base hit, grounding onto the hole at shortstop. That'll bring up Ted Simmons, who struck out in the second inning. Well, Ted hit two home runs in St. Louis on fastballs. And we'll watch and see how LaPointe works him with a runner at first and one out in the fourth inning. Cardinals 4, Milwaukee nothing, bottom of the fourth inning. Milwaukee blanked last night by Andujar. Waited until the eighth inning before scoring. And it was too late. The pitch to Simmons in the dirt. One ball and no strike. Milwaukee shut out only once during the regular year by Jack O'Connell here in Milwaukee. LaPointe on and off the rubber, now looks in to get a sign. Simmons waiting in the 1-0 pitch to Ted. Half swing as he looked like he turned over the change, and that had a lot of motion on it.
Benny, you can't even tell his changeup. This young man, in about another year or two, he's going to be awful with that changeup. He's going to be awful tough to hit.
Boy, that thing really floated down and away from Simmons, who just did lay off going after it. 2-0 to Ted. On deck, Gorman Thomas. LaPointe out of a stretch in the 2-0 pitch. Inside, ball three, and now this crowd is alive. They had their spirits dampened when the Cardinals scored in the first inning. They were really down when the Cardinals scored three more in the second. 3-0, the count of Ted Simmons. Gorman Thomas on deck. LaPointe out of a stretch, delivers. Fastball in there, 3-1. Well, his home runs hit on fastballs, and the last one was a 3-1 fastball in St. Louis that he really hit out of sight. So we'll see how LaPointe pitches him 3-1 with a runner at first and one out. Fastball, but he is low with it. Ball four. And now the Brewers have a chance to get back in the game as Gorman Thomas coming up with two on, one out, fourth inning. Cardinals leading 4-0, and Keith Hernandez over to LaPointe to give him a little bit of a pep talk. And they are moving around in the Cardinal bullpen, although there isn't anyone throwing yet. LaPointe on the rubber, and Gorman Thomas taking a practice swing. Gorman had been in quite a slump. Then last night, he singled and lost a two-run home run on a great catch by Willie McGee. Jeff Lottie gets up in the Cardinal bullpen, and the pitch is low. Ball one. And Darryl Porter says, give me time. I got to talk to my man out there. And Hub Kittle, the pitching coach, just trotting out to the mound. Hub Kittle, in his pitching days, suffered a freak accident. He was pitching in San Francisco, and the hitter hit a foul ball. And Hub was deep in thought, and the umpire put a new ball in play, fired the ball out of the mound, and he hit Kittle right in the eye. And Hub, knocked flat, had to be carried out of the game. Maybe the only time a pitcher was ever knocked out by an umpire. Maybe.
Maybe.
All right, Hub goes walking back to the Cardinal dugout. One ball and no strikes, the count to Gorman Thomas. Two on, one out, and the big home run hitter at the plate. Boy, listen to this crowd now. Milwaukee alive again. And Gorman Thomas climbs in. Dave LaPointe leaning on his right knee, facing his first severe challenge of the day. On deck is Ben Ogilvy, and now LaPointe wants to talk to Porter again. You wouldn't think they're changing the signs, would you?
He might be changing the signs. LaPointe might have a feeling that somebody out there at second, Mr. Cooper, might be calling some pitches.
All right, Porter now goes behind the plate. Two on, one out, fourth inning. St. Louis 4, Milwaukee nothing. And Gorman Thomas waiting. LaPointe staring in. Now the big left-hander straightens up and deals fastball. It's hopped in the air, foul behind the plate and off to the right. Porter coming back to the seats at the railing and makes the catch for the out. And Gorman Thomas flips his bat in the air disgustedly and walks away. Good play by Darryl Porter.
Great play by Porter. He went right directly to the ball. The ball's coming back a little just proper. He kept his back right to the playing field, and the ball just drifted right back to him.
He also might have gotten a break defensively. The sun right now is hidden behind a rather large pewter gray cloud overhead. So when Porter turned, he didn't have to look into a spotlight. Ben Ogilvy, who tripled off the wall in left center field in the second inning coming up. Two on, two out, 4-0 St. Louis in the fourth. LaPointe out of a stretch. He just got a big man. With a fastball, he gets a strike on Ogilvy. No runs, three hits for Milwaukee. Cooper singled here in the fourth. Simmons walked. But now there are two outs. The strike one pitch is high and inside. One ball, one strike. Cardinals scored a run in the first, three in the second, and the Brewers yet to recover from it. Ogilvy hitting 154. The 1-1 pitch he takes outside, one-handed by Darryl Porter. Ball two, 2-1.
Vinny's a big man for him to get out because he's got two outs. If he gets, lets Ogilvy get on, he's got money coming up to reach those seats very easy.
He already got a big man, Gorman Thomas. Now he's asked to get another one and get out of the inning. And Jeff Lottie, the right-hander, throwing down in the Cardinal bullpen. LaPointe out of a stretch in the 2-1 pitch. Fastball high. Ball three. 3-1. Well, the way Harvey Keene has been playing, I would assume Ogilvy has the green light, 3-1.
They're turning him loose here, and they hope that he can pick up three runs for him.
Ogilvy pumping Ed Wood back and forth. He's Mr. Busy up there at the plate. Boy, he cranks it and wiggles it, and the 3-1 pitch swung on. A ground ball to Hernandez, and he'll bring it to the bag. So the Brewers leave two, and at the end of four, Cardinals four, Milwaukee nothing.
WMAQ.
We're up to our ears in audio technology here at the Delco Electronics Testing Lab in Kokomo, Indiana.
Speaking of ears, who's the guy in the red jumpsuit sitting in the Buick Riviera? He's got microphones where his ears are supposed to be.
That's Morgan, a mechanical person. I was getting to him.
Sorry.
3 years ago, Delco Electronics and the prestigious Bose Corporation.
Like in Bose speakers?
That's right. Mm-hmm. Decided to combine their technologies.
Yeah.
The result is the Delco GM Bose music system. The first system with components matched to a specific car model. That's where Morgan comes in.
The guy with the microphone ears, huh?
Yes, he's into psychoacoustics. He's helped position the loudspeakers, even the design of the amplifiers to fit different GM cars.
Mm-hmm. You guys went through a lot of trouble.
Yes, we did. The acoustical differences received by Morgan's ears were computerized.
Computerized?
Why not? Delco's the number one digital control computer manufacturer.
In the whole world?
And above the world. Delco's making one of the computers that'll be launched by the space shuttle.
And will the space shuttle also have a Delco GM Bose music system on board?
I'll have to check on that.
Hey, aren't you...
Bob Newhart.
Bob, what's happening, Bob? What's new?
Well, I've got a new show on CBS TV this fall.
Great, Bob. When? What network?
I play a writer who buys a historic inn in Vermont.
Well, what's it about?
About a half an hour.
Bob, now you stay right here. I gotta get Stan. He's not gonna believe it's you. Hey, Stan, come here. Look who's here. It's Bob Newhart.
Hi.
Are you really Bob Newhart?
Yeah.
Well, you sure look alike.
Premieres Monday, October 25th at 9:30, 8:30 Central and Mountain, right after MASH on CBS TV.
While we have a moment, we'd like to send along special greetings from all of us at CBS Radio to those of you around the world listening to the World Series on Armed Forces Radio. We can also duck in another football score. In a traditional battle that is almost a war, Alabama 7, Tennessee 3 in the second quarter. In the fifth inning, Ken Obergefell, followed by Keith Hernandez and then George Hendrick. Cardinals scoring 1 in the first, 3 in the second, and the Brewers unable to get started. Yount had a base hit in the first inning, but Cooper lined into a double play. Ogilvie, a two-out triple in the second, but they left him. And then first and second in the fourth with one out, and they failed to advance. So the Brewers have left three, the Cardinals have left three, and here is Obergefell, who hooks one foul off the bunting of the box seats outside of first. 0-1. Obergefell doubled to right in the first inning and scored a run, walked and scored in the second inning. Obi, left-hand hitter waiting, Molitor about even with the bag. The outfield split with Gorman Thomas shading a little towards left center. Obergefell hits a ground ball to Gantner and Jim throws him out. Moose Hawes has turned around in the first two innings. He made 58 pitches. Then he really improved on that. The next two innings, he only made 21 pitches. And he has only allowed a bunt single, actually a check swing. Remember that bunt by Ozzie Smith in the fourth inning that Molitor picked up with two hands and then couldn't get him. So Haas has settled down, but it's a question of whether it's too late or not. Hernandez takes outside, ball one. And I would guess that's really heresy here in Milwaukee to say too late when you're only down by four.
No, except one thing. You keep working closer to Suter. Every inning that a point can pitch well, he's closer to the big guy.
One ball and no strikes to Keith Hernandez. Haas into the windup. Moose back with a pitch that's fouled away off to the left and out of play. Hernandez is 0-2, so Keith is 0-13. 1-1 to Hernandez. It's amazing how many times over the years in the World Series the big name draws blanks. The 1-1 pitch, Hernandez way out in front. He started his swing yesterday.
I think the big guys come in and they're trying to show the other club and all the fans, you know, why they're the big guy. The little guy, nobody bothers him. He just goes on about his work.
1-2 the count. Keith Hernandez way out in front on Haas change. Moose picks off the sign from Simmons. The right-hander back 1-2, and one change deserves another. A one-hopper to Robin Yount, who throws to Cooper and gets him. Back-to-back change-ups.
Yeah, back-to-back change-ups, and Hernandez was right on that ball. You know, he's hit two balls now extremely hard and directly where Yount just one way or the other, the ball's a base hit.
With two out in the fifth inning, George Hendrick coming up. He hit that high chopper in the first inning over the mound. Robin Yount trying to short hop it on the dead run. Couldn't. The ball kicked off his glove and caromed out onto the grass in shallow right field. And on the play, Obergefell scored from second base. Hendrick is 1-2 with an RBI. Haas ready and delivers. George swings and doesn't get it. 0-1. The last man to really get a base hit was McGee, who singled in the second inning. Haas has turned it around, but it's 4-0 St. Louis. The strike one pitch on the way. Hendrick takes high and outside. 1-1. Top of the fifth inning, Cardinals 4-0. For Milwaukee, the best thing about the game thus far is the weather. Hendrick with that closed stance, waiting at the plate. Haas 1-1 pitch on the way. Hendrick takes a strike, 1-2. I asked you before about Cecil Cooper's open stance, so now I'll ask you, what does a closed stance tell you about a hitter?
Well, a closed stance tells me, truthfully, he likes that ball inside. He's usually going to open up that front foot and step away a little bit.
1-2 the count. Hendrick waiting. Haas into the windup, and Moose comes back, and George hits a drive to center. Gorman Thomas has it on his radar screen and makes the catch. So they're gone in order in the fifth. And at the end of 4.5, Cardinals 4-0.
We're American and we're giving our best.
News, Chicago.
We're giving you
three nonstops to Philadelphia.
We're giving our best.
Starting November 1st, you can fly to Philadelphia on American, because that's when we'll begin new service to Philadelphia with three daily nonstops. And best of all, you'll get the same great service you've come to expect from American. For information and reservations, call your travel agent or American Airlines. If you're flying to Philadelphia, don't take off without the American Express card. Use the card to pay for your American Airlines tickets. Plus, you'll find the card welcomed almost everywhere you go. At hotels, fine restaurants, and for car rentals. The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
For an inside look at the stories in the sports world, CBS Radio has two daily shows which will interest you. Sports Time with Brent Musburger and Kurt Gowdy on Sports. Brent is keeping a watchful eye on such issues as the NFL labor negotiations. Kurt serves up interviews with the big names in sports. Brent Musburger and Kurt Gowdy. Hear them here on most of these CBS stations. In the bottom of the fifth inning, I'm Vin Scully along with Sparky Anderson, the manager of the Detroit Tigers. And for Milwaukee, it'll be Don Money, followed by Charlie Moore and then Jim Gantner. Dave LaPointe wiggled off a hook in the fourth inning. With two on and one out, he was in trouble. Jeff Lottie was throwing in the bullpen, and Gorman Thomas was the hitter. And he got Thomas to foul to Darryl Porter, and then went 3-1 on Ogilvy and got him to ground to Keith Hernandez. So now LaPointe ready to start afresh again. The left-hander into the windup and delivers, and the first pitch to Money high and outside. Don struck out in the second inning. Dave LaPointe, he was 23 in July. The 1-0 pitch on the way, and Money backs off and takes a strike, 1-1. LaPointe started pitching back in 1977. 1-1 pitch coming up, way outside and high. Ball two, 2-1. He's 6'3", 205-pounder. Don Money all the while just waiting at the plate. And LaPointe, after thinking over the situation, back up on the hill and looks in to get a sign. Dave was the pitcher when the Cardinals clinched the Eastern Division title this year. Money drives one to left center. On the dead run is Willie McGee at the wall, and it goes off his glove this time. And into second base goes Money with a double.
I'm surprised there, Vinny. Now, that was a very easy catch. I think what he did is he kind of just Cadillac'd at that last 10, 15 yards. He was just Cadillac'd, and that ball should have been hit, put in his hip pocket.
Yep. So Willie McGee got his glove on it, didn't hold it. They charitably give Money the double. So actually the two extra base hits against LaPointe, the triple by Ogilvy might have been caught by someone other than Lonnie Smith, and now this double by Money might very well have been caught by many of the center fielders in the league, in both leagues. And here is Charlie Moore, slide to center in the third. So the Brewers get a break. They've gotten a couple, but they can't cash him in. And Charlie Moore heaves a sigh and now checks in. LaPointe out of a stretch. looks back at money, comes to Moore, and he fouled it away. 0-1. Let's pause 5 seconds for stations to identify themselves.
It's Jimmy Pearsall after the game on 67 WMAQ Chicago.
Charlie Moore looking down at third. Harry Warner perhaps hanging out a sign. The Cardinal infield is back, and the outfield, especially Willie McGee, very deep in center. So Don Money, a double off McGee's glove. And LaPointe leaning on his right knee, hiding the ball back of his left hip as he studies Darryl Porter's sign. Strike one pitch on the way. Swung on and a dunker to center. We told you McGee was deep, and that's going to land in front of him for a base hit. Boy, he was playing Charlie Moore as if he was one of the great home run hitters in the league.
Yeah, I don't quite understand it, Benny. I've noticed all along that he plays an awful, awful deep center field, and I don't understand with a man with his speed why he would play deep. It's so much easier for him to outrun that ball going back.
Remember what I told you about his base running? He's a little timid.
Well, when you play that deep in center field, no wonder he's catching those balls. I had a little suspicion last night when he caught those two balls off the fence. He got there awful easy.
So runners at first and third, nobody out in the fifth inning. And Jim Gantner, Paul Molitor, and Robin Yount. And LaPointe could very easily have retired the first two batters. Instead, he's in trouble again. And Jeff Lottie gets up for the second time in the Cardinal bullpen. Gantner grounded to third in the third inning. Oberfell is up about even with the bag. A throw to first, diving back is Moore. Doug Bear will check. And the pitch of the plate, missing ball one, 1-0. They're still moving, and it's John Martin who will now start the throw. Martin and Lottie, John Martin, a left-hander, in the Cardinal bullpen. 1-0, the count of Jim Gantner. Darryl Porter out to the mound to kind of Dutch uncle his man, talk to him along. Coming in from shortstop briefly, Ozzie Smith. So Don Money doubled off Willie McGee's glove. Then Moore hit a fly ball that dropped for a base hit because McGee was playing him in Madison. And here is Gantner. And no pitch, just as LaPointe is ready. Plate umpire Dave Phillips was gesturing, no, no, don't come to the plate. Time out.
You know, Benny, there's a case of really, he should have two outs and nobody on.
Right. All right, LaPointe straightens up, looks at the runners and the 1-0 pitch. Gander takes a strike and the count 1-1. 4-0 St. Louis, but the Brewers, with a chance in the fourth inning, couldn't cash it in. And now a golden opportunity in the fifth. First and third, nobody out. LaPointe out of a stretch. The left-hander's 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball. Hit up along first base. Foul. And the count 1-2. Boy, I tell you what almost happened but didn't. Keith Hernandez going into foul ground and the ball hit the edge of the grass and almost kicked back fair. It just did skirt first base and stay foul, but Hernandez really gave that area of ground a dirty look. 1-2 the count. Tommy Herr shading Gantner up the middle. He's not playing into full, so the right side is wide open. LaPointe delivers. Fastball hit back of the mound behind second. Fielded by Ozzie Smith. He steps on second and doubled him at first. Ozzie Smith flashing across the bag. Turns it into a double play. Scoring from third is Don Money. The ball just couldn't quite get through for Gantner. Ozzie Smith, barely avoiding a collision with Tommy Herr, got the double play. Is he something?
He's outstanding, Benny. And I'll tell you what, there's very few shortstops would have ever tagged that second base and went on to first. They'd have come across, got the ball, and went to first.
So that's the second double play for the Cardinals. Two out in the fifth inning. Milwaukee picks up a run. It's now Cardinals 4, Brewers 1. And the batter is Paul Molitor, and the pitch in the dirt. And it came up over the shoulder of Darryl Porter and almost got Dave Phillips. One ball and no strikes the count. Well, it's the thing about baseball that's incredible. Two suspect plays in center field and then turn right around and get a dazzler for two quick outs.
Well, when you have a shortstop like that, though, those things happen all year for you.
The 1-0 pitch on the way, very high. Knocked down, a backhanded effort by Darryl Porter. On deck, Robin Yount. And again, Hernandez and Ozzie Smith trying to come to the mound and soothe his feathers a little bit. LaPointe perhaps trying to throw beyond himself, trying to get something extra, so he bounces the curve and then almost throws the fastball to the screen.
You know, Benny, what it really is, it's got 4 2/3 innings, and he needs one more out to get this win, and this is what happens to young pitchers.
2-0 the count. LaPointe into the windup, and the 2-0 pitch, Molitor takes a strike as he faked a bunt. He hit Keith Hernandez on the move, and so was Ken Obergfeld. Molitor grounded to third and struck out in his two previous at-bats. So Paul 0 for 2. LaPointe's 2-1 pitch on the way is swung on and hit foul outside of third down the line. 2-2. Four runs, five hits for the Cardinals. One run, five hits, and an error for Milwaukee. But upon close inspection of the Cardinal four runs, they're just about all suspect. So it's been that kind of a game. Molitor waiting 2-2. LaPointe says no to Porter. Now he's ready. And the 2-2 pitch on the way. Fastball, slap foul down the right field line, out of play. 2-2. LaPointe taking a little walk behind the mound, working on a new ball. All the while, Molitor just waiting in the box. LaPointe into the windup, and his 2-2 pitch is a fastball fouled away. Down and in. Molitor just able to handle it and fouled it away. Molitor hitting .412 with seven hits in the series. Just picked up five in a hurry opening night. 2-2 pitch. The right-hand hitting third baseman is lifted into left center field, and McGee is there. Willie comes up to handle it, and that's it. So Milwaukee gets a run, and at the end of five, Cardinals 4, Brewers 1.
WMAQ.
Do you think you're paying more than you have to for your car insurance? Check with State Farm. State Farm was built on low car insurance rates. You'll get a good price. You'll also find the kind of protection you need, the personal service you deserve, and the fast, fair claims handling State Farm is famous for. For a great value in car insurance, see a good neighbor agent now. Check with State Farm.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
If we told you here about the mileage you get with a Honda Civic four-door wagon, we wouldn't have time to tell you about its generous interior space, that it comes loaded with practical standard equipment, and that it's one of the lowest-priced wagons in America. So, spend a little time with your Honda dealer and learn about its mileage. Our time is up.
For over 100 years, America has had a passionate love affair with baseball. Baseball has become more than the national pastime. It has become a vital part of the fabric of American life. Historian Jacques Barzin summed it up best when he wrote this classic line: "Whoever wants to know the heart and mind of America had better learn baseball." Baseball fever. Catch it. It lasts forever.
The preceding message was furnished by Major League Baseball.
At County Stadium in Milwaukee, we move to the sixth inning with the Cardinals leading the Brewers 4-1. Darryl Porter, followed by Lonnie Smith and Dane Orts, the designated hitter, against right-hander Moose Haas, who has certainly settled down. But the big question, of course, has he settled down too late? He has not only retired the side in order in the fifth inning, he has allowed only a bunt single since Willie McGee singled in the second inning. And again, we should look at those Cardinal runs. Obergfeld doubled with two out. Hendrick hit just a big high bouncer over the mound, and that meant a run. Robin Yount unable to short hop it. Then in the second inning, McGee singled, stole second. Ozzie Smith walked with one out, a wild pitch, moved them to second and third. Tommy Herr then hit a long fly ball to center, in which Gorman Thomas had trouble first getting a jump, and then when he went back to get it, he caught it, got his feet tangled, and fell down. Well, not only did Willie McGee score from third, Ozzie Smith came home from second. Then Obergfeld walked, stole second, and he came home on an error by Gantner. The point being, it's not even a case of Haas settling down. He really didn't, well, he wasn't up. And the first pitch to Darryl Porter is low, ball one.
Like you said, the most runs they should have to offer Haas is one at the most.
One ball and no strikes to Darryl Porter. Singled and hit back to the box. Oz into the windup. Back he comes 1-0, and Porter takes a strike. 1-1. But that's the maddeningly wonderful thing about this game.
It's what drives you crazy.
1-1 to Porter. Moose Haas into the windup, delivers, and missed inside. Ball two. 2-1. 4 runs, 5 hits, no errors for the Cardinals. 1 run, 5 hits, and 1 error for Milwaukee. Darryl Porter hitting .385. He has 5 hits in the series and 2 RBIs that got the birds even. In fact, it has all been St. Louis, really, ever since Porter's doubled the left field against Don Sutton. He fouls the next pitch back. 2-2. Remember how Milwaukee came in and won the first game 10-0 and immediately took a 2-0 lead, then a 3-2 lead, and they were leading 4-2 when Porter doubled to tie up the game 4-4. And then the Cardinals got the winning run in the 8th inning to get a split at home and came back to win here last night. And the Cardinals leading again today 4-1. So the double left by Porter just seemed to press a button and get the Cardinals going. The 2-2 pitch to Darryl. Off speed and away. Ball three. Full count to Darryl Porter. Opening up matters here in the 6th inning. In the bottom of the 6th inning, Robin Yount, Cecil Cooper, and Ted Simmons coming up from Milwaukee. 3-2 pitch. Porter swings and misses. Down he goes. Boy, he really wound up to take a swing at that one.
Yeah, he was going to try to hit that over the bleachers in right field.
So Darryl Porter cranks up and comes up empty. 1 down, and Lonnie Smith the batter. For Moose Haas, his 3rd strikeout. The other 2 came in the 1st inning. Lonnie Smith hit into a force play and then hit that old little soft line drive, if there be such a thing, back to Haas in the 3rd. Right-hander into the windup. Haas delivers, and Lonnie holds up. The pitch is low. Ball 1. 1-0. Tomorrow, 4:35 Eastern Time. It's Game 5 here at County Stadium. Mike Caldwell and Bob Forsch. Line drive over 3rd and down the line. Going in the corner to get it is Ben Ogilvy. And Lonnie Smith goes breezing into 2nd base with a double. Well, he had a double and a triple last night. And now comes back with a double today. Hit number 6 for St. Louis. And it'll bring up Dane Orge, who fly to center and pop to short, 0-2. Haas scraping of the dirt atop the rubber, and they're moving around again in the Milwaukee bullpen, and Jim Slayton is going to get up for the 2nd time. Haas hands it aside, reading Ted Simmons. Orge trying to pick up Lonnie Smith. Haas from a stretch, a look at 2nd, now comes to the hitter and picks up a strike on the outside corner. On deck, Willie McGee. Oh, and 1 to Orge. 4-1 St. Louis, 6th inning, 1 away. Lonnie Smith, a double over 3rd. Molitor trying to make a diving backhand catch of the ball, but didn't come close. Hiller trying to shepherd Lonnie Smith a little bit as he takes his lead at 2nd. And the strike 1 pitch, Orge takes outside. 1 ball, 1 strike. Haas trying to come up with a change and maybe get him to go after it, but he wouldn't bite. Orge hitting .250 in the series with 2 hits. Dane flied to center, popped a short in his 2 previous at-bats. Haas comes to him, and a fastball is swung on and missed. So following the change, he came with the fastball. And Moose Haas, at this juncture with that fastball, has now made 100 pitches, and we're in the 6th inning. Mike Ryan, who does such a great job for the Houston Astros all year. Mike, formerly with the San Diego Padres, and we are indebted to Mike Ryan for all of his great work during the series. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Lonnie's going to 3rd, and there's a fly ball into right center field. It will fall for a base hit. It gets by Charlie Moore. The run scores, and by the time Gorman Thomas gets it in, standing at 2nd is Dane Orge with a double. And it is 5-1 St. Louis. And now Harvey Keene making his way out of the Brewer dugout and going to the mound. With one out in the sixth, after Hawes had pitched so well at the end of the second inning into the sixth, he is touched up for doubles by Lonnie Smith and Dane Ords. And Harvey making his way to the hill. Down in the bullpen, Jim Slayton has been throwing, and Harvey is going to Slayton. So that will do it for Moose Hawes. Slayton picking up in the sixth inning, and he'll be pitching to Willie McGee. So Hawes went 5 1/3. He allowed 7 hits, walked 2, struck out 3, and at least 5 runs. Orge at second base belongs to Hawes. Of course, when Hawes beat the Angels, he gave up 5 runs, but he won 9-5 in that game.
Yeah, he had a big early lead, and he really hung on there. He was getting the ball back up again, though, Ben. He started getting up good.
Well, while the new pitcher, Jim Slayton, is warming up, let's pause for this.
WMAQ. You gotta reach deep inside. Come on, bring out that pride.
You've known the challenge, the need to excel. And all you do to bring out your best.
Bring out your best. Bring out your best. Bring out your best.
The challenge for us was to brew a light beer worthy of the king of beers. One with a clean, distinctive taste. Budweiser Light lives up to the challenge.
Bring out your best.
Budweiser Light, it took time, patience, and a commitment to quality. But then, the best never comes easy. That's why there's nothing else like it.
Budweiser Light.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
This fall from Motorcraft. Get up to $9.50 in refunds on some of the highest quality automotive products you can buy for any make of car. Save up to $4 on Motorcraft spark plugs and $1 on Motorcraft oil and air filters. Save $1.50 on 5 quarts of Motorcraft oil. Plus, get $2 in bonus refunds on qualifying purchases. See your Motorcraft retailer for details now through November 30th. Motorcraft automotive products from Ford for the future of your car, for sure.
In the sixth inning, the Cardinals have picked up a run with one out on back-to-back doubles by Lonnie Smith and Dane Orge. They have chased Moose Hawes, and James Michael Slayton will pick up. Slayton, an even 685-pounder, and he's 32 years old from Long Beach, California, makes his home in Lancaster, California. Tell us about Slayton, Spark.
Well, Slayton's fastball slider, and that's basically what he goes with. Every now and then he'll change up a little bit, but doesn't like to use his change much, Benny. Fastball slider.
The 1981 season, he was coming back from a slight tear to the rotator cuff, and of course that has ruined a lot of pitchers.
He's been the only one that I've really seen come back from it. He throws every bit as good as he did before it happened, and of course I don't believe he had the full tear.
Slayton, a 10-game winner. He was 10-6 during the year, and he worked well over 100 innings. So Slayton making his World Series debut. He was originally selected by the Seattle Pilots way back in 1969. Remember, the heritage of Milwaukee. They purchased a bankrupt Seattle Pilot club in 1970, and Slayton was in the Seattle organization then. So Jim, out of a stretch, looks back at Orge at second, and Willie McGee at the plate promptly drives a fly ball to left field, but it's playable. Ogilvy is there to handle it, and Lonnie Smith holding in the dugout as Dane Orge stays at second base, and the batter now will be Ozzie Smith. 5-1 St. Louis here in the sixth inning. To repeat, Robin Yount, Cecil Cooper, and Ted Simmons coming up in that order for Milwaukee. Slayton looks in to get a sign from Simmons. Ozzie Smith hitting left-handed, waiting, and the right-hander's first pitch a little high, ball one. With the Cardinals pecking away, you realize the job that Mike Caldwell turned in opening night to go the distance and beat him. And you also realize the monumental task that Caldwell faces pitching tomorrow.
And also, I think, Benny, when you turn the Cardinals around to right-handed, basically you're better off.
The 1-0 pitch is popped in the air, foul off to the left out of play into the crowd behind the Cardinal dugout. 1-1, the count to Ozzie Smith. So the Cardinals with a run in the first, three in the second, and one here in the sixth. The only Brewer run came in the fifth inning. Slayton out of a stretch, looks at second, works his hitter, and flips it in there nicely for a strike. One and two. Boy, he really stiff-wristed that thing.
Yeah, he's not a bad pitcher, and I tell you, when he's got his good control, he's really a good pitcher.
Slayton on the rubber. Jim checking, and Simmons wigwagging a couple of signs out, and the 1-2 pitch on the way. Ozzie, it's a ground ball to short. Yount picks it up, flips across to Cooper. Safe. He pulled him off the bag. The throw was into the runner, and Cooper had to go right into runner Ozzie Smith, and in doing that, he came off the bag, so Yount draws an error. That's what speed will do for you. Robin Yount picks it up, but he knows it's Ozzie Smith hitting left-handed, and he has to hurry.
That's the thing the Cardinals really have shown me, that they all run well, except, of course, Porter and Ord.
That means the Brewers have now made a half a dozen errors, two today and three last night. They made one error in the two games in St. Louis. So first and third, two out. Remember, Ozzie was picked off the last time he was aboard in the fourth inning. So we'll see if he tries to steal with a runner at third. Tommy Herr is the batter, struck out, had the scoring fly ball and fly to center, and a throw to first. Ozzie goes back in with a hand. When they picked him off, he went in with his feet, stumbled, and came off the bag. Ozzie taking his lead. Slayton set, looks at him, now comes to the plate, and Tommy Herr swings and doesn't get it. 0-1. St. Louis 5, Milwaukee 1 in the sixth. Here in the inning, Porter struck out. Lonnie Smith doubled to left. Orge doubled to right center to score him. McGee flied to left, but Ozzie Smith reaches on the error by Yount, with Orge taking third.
Benny, here's one of those situations. If Smith does steal, Org won't go, I don't believe, with two out. They will gamble that Smith can steal it.
0-1 the count. Ozzie doesn't go, and Herr hits one right at Robin Yount. So they wind up with a run, two hits, an error, and two left. And at the end of five and a half, the Cardinals 5, Milwaukee 1.
WMAQ.
Prestone would like to take you on a journey into an inferno, into a world of screaming pistons, exploding gases, temperatures topping 4,000 degrees. Into the world where your radiator works, cooling the blast furnace you call a car engine. It's murder. The hotter today's cars run, the easier all that heat makes it for rust and corrosion to build up in your cooling system. Without Prestone protection, you could be heading for trouble after just 10,000 miles of driving on weak, neglected antifreeze. Trouble such as boilovers, burned valves, even a cracked cylinder head could happen to you if the rust builds up enough. So protect your radiator. Drain it every year and put in fresh Prestone 2 with patented silicone silicate. Prestone 2 fights rust. Deep inside, trust Prestone.
At Buick, we believe that a car that gives you more miles from the gas tank doesn't have to give you less of anything else. That's the philosophy that makes our Skylark quite possibly the best disguised economy car in America. Striking good looks, a stylish, comfortable interior with generous room for five are combined with a remarkable 27 EPA estimated MPG. Use estimated MPG for comparison. Actual mileage may be different. Buick Skylark. Economy beautifully disguised.
As we go to the bottom of the sixth inning and the Cardinals sitting on top of a 5-1 lead, we get a stadium record attendance, four more people than last night. The attendance, 56,560. 56,560. Robin Yount had the infield single and hit back to the box. So Robin trying to get something started before this record crowd at County Stadium. LaPointe into the windup. Dave delivers ground ball back to LaPointe, who makes a fine defensive play and throws him out. I don't know if he's that good a fielder or just lucky.
Well, Benny, I tell you what, if he's that good a fielder, we got to play him somewhere else when he's not pitching, because he's just a line shot, just reached down like it was picking cherries.
So a fine defensive play, taking a base hit away from Robin Yount. One out, and Cecil Cooper the batter. Cooper lined into a double play and had the infield single in the fourth inning as he hit one to the hole at short. LaPointe looks in to Darryl Porter. Cecil Cooper is not quite ready to hit yet. Cardinals 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. And Milwaukee 1 run, 5 hits, and 2 errors. It's been Haas and Slayton and LaPointe working for St. Louis. And the left-hand is high to Coop. Ball 1-0. Cecil 1-for-2. That makes him 5-for-15. And he lifts a fly ball to right field. And George Hendrick is there looking up and makes the catch for the out. So Cooper a fly ball to right. 2 down in the 6th inning. And Ted Simmons, who has struck out and walked, coming up. Simmons hitting right-handed. Gorman Thomas on deck. The Brewers kept in check up to here by Dave LaPointe, who buzzes a strike, 0-1. Brewers had a runner at third with 2 out in the 2nd inning. 1st and 2nd, 1 out in the 4th. And finally broke through for a run in the 5th inning. Pitch swung on and missed by Ted Simmons in the count 0-2. But LaPointe has pitched very well. Haas pitched better than the score would indicate. Here's the strike 2 pitch. Little fly ball to straightaway center, and McGee is there. Willie waiting, puts it away, and it's a very easy 6th inning for Dave LaPointe. And at the end of 6, Cardinals 5, Milwaukee 1.
WMAQ.
This does for you. Been on the job and working hard all day. So here's to you. You know there's no one else who does it quite the way you do. For all you do, this bug for you.
Friends, wherever you are, election night, November 2nd, follow the results with CBS News on most of these stations. 2 reports each hour, plus net alert, bulletins when results can't wait. Stay in touch with every development. Election night with CBS News. Hear it here. Sparky, I was just wondering, in looking at last night's game, where the Brewers were shut out into the 8th inning, looking at today's game, where they're fortunate to have 1 run, are the Cardinal pitchers doing something different than the American League pitchers do to stop this wrecking crew that is not wrecking?
Well, if you take a look at the Milwaukee Ball Club, I believe going into that playoffs with California, of course, they got beat the first 2 ball games in that one, but Baltimore, you know, took them right to the hill and beat them.
Doubleheader, then beat them the next day, and then finally they
had little problems with us. They had some problems prior with Cleveland. So they have been having problems, I'd say, the last 3 weeks. And the reason is I think they hit so much during the season, they just wore themselves out.
Well, into the 7th inning we go with the Cardinals leading 5-1. Ken Obergfeld, followed by Keith Hernandez and then George Hendrick. Because I was wondering if, boy, the American League managers are suddenly going to learn something.
Well, I think we are learning one thing. The Cardinal people are doing what you're supposed to do with them.
The first pitch in the dirt all the way to the backstop by Jim Slayton. 1 ball and no strikes. In other words, Obergfeld swings, fouls it away. 2-1. Obergfeld drew blanks last night, which stopped his streak. He had hit in the championship series and in the World Series. Stopped last night, but he has come right back with a double and a walk today. Went 0-for-4 last evening. Slayton turns on the rubber. The 2-1 pitch flipped a little high. Ball 3. 3-1. We're in the 7th inning of Game 4, and the Cardinals holding a 2-1 advantage and holding a 5-1 lead, and the pitch fouled away upstairs off to the left. 3-2 the count to Ken Obergfeld. Tomorrow, Mike Caldwell and Bob Forrest.
You know, Benny, it's funny. You go down there, lineup 091, her, Obergfeld 300, 111, Hendricks, 182, Lonnie Smith. You say, how are they ahead?
0-0-0, Hernandez. The number three hitter still looking for a base hit in the series. And there's ball four to Ken Obergfeld. And here comes Keith now. Hernandez struck out, was aboard on an error, and grounded out. He's 0 for 3. That makes him 0 for 14 in the series. St. Louis 5, Milwaukee 1 in the 7th. Obergfeld at first, nobody out. Slayton ready, and there goes Obergfeld. A one-hopper banged at Gantner. He goes to Yount, back to Cooper, double play. Boy, Hernandez is really lucky, isn't he?
In all fairness to poor Hernandez, he's been hitting that ball awful good not to have no base hit.
Did he ever rip that? A one-hopper banged at Gantner. And even though Obergfeld was on the dead run, they get the easy double play. 4-6-3. And Hernandez goes back to the dugout wondering if one will ever fall his way. He's now 0 for 15 in the series. George Hendrick had an infield single, fouled out and flied out. Hendrick takes low, ball one. When the Brewers bat in the bottom of the seventh inning, Gorman Thomas, Ben Ogilvy, and Don Money. One and 0 to George. Darryl Porter waiting his turn on deck. Slayton rocks without a windup, comes to the plate, and a breaking ball a strike, even though the pitcher lost his hat. 1-1 the count. Five runs, seven hits for the Cardinals. They've had three doubles by Obergfeld, Lonnie Smith, and Dane Orge. The 1-1 pitch, Hendrick, a check swing, and he rolls it to Gantner. Jim has a lot of time, just picks it up and flips him. So thanks to the double play, the 1-2-3 inning. And at the end of 6.5, the Cardinals 5, Milwaukee 1.
WMAQ.
If you're looking for health insurance at a good price, check with State Farm. Ask about the affordable health insurance that comes with Good Neighbor Service. State Farm offers protection that respects your budget. And just as important, your State Farm agent will provide the kind of help you need to plan that protection wisely. For the health insurance that comes with Good Neighbor Service, check with State Farm.
And like a good neighbor,
this way I can go to college and be in the Army.
One weekend a month, college freshman Stephanie DeMarcus earns money for college in the Army Reserve.
On split option, you go to your basic and then you can return back to school. And then you go to your advanced individual training. It's a good part-time job.
If you'd like to earn over $12,000 for college while you're going to college, call your Army Reserve recruiter listed in the yellow pages and ask about the split training option. Paid for by the Army Reserve.
Bottom of the seventh inning here at County Stadium in Milwaukee. The crowd singing the familiar refrain, take me out to the ballgame. It has not been much of a ballgame for the Milwaukee Brewers. Now they're asking the Brewers to roll out the barrel. Well, it'll be Gorman Thomas, Ben Ogilvy, and then Don Money. Dave LaPointe has allowed just one run and four hits. Down in the bullpen, Doug Bear begins to tune up. The right-hander, so LaPointe, going along nicely, retired the side in the sixth inning. And now in the seventh, Gorman Thomas. Thomas flied to center in the second inning, came up in the fourth with runners at first and second and one out. And Thomas fouled out to Darryl Porter. Gorman Thomas, right-hand hitting center fielder, who also suffered the indignity in the second inning of going back to the track to catch the long fly ball and then fall down, so that two runs scored on the fly ball. Gorman struggling. Last night lost a home run on that great leaping catch by Willie McGee. Well, Gorman Thomas at the plate. Thomas hitting 154 in the series. Case of another big hitter who has been shut down. Two hits and 13 at-bats. The Cardinals load up the left side as Tommy Herr goes to the other side of the bag. Thomas hits a towering foul. Porter coming back after it. He has a play. He's got the ball. And for the second at bat, Gorman Thomas fouls out. So one away in the seventh inning, and Ben Ogilvie the batter. Ogilvie tripled in the second inning, grounded out in the fourth. Do you have any theory, Sparky, about talking to your hitters as the game gets, let's say, into the seventh inning, asking them to take a pitch because maybe the fella's getting a little tired?
Well, I'll take a pitch once we get into the eighth. If we're losing more than two runs, I want somebody to take a pitch.
The pitch is strike to Ben Ogilvie, 0-1. A one-out seventh inning, 5-1 St. Louis. Five runs, seven hits for the Cardinals. One run, five hits, two errors for Milwaukee, and the fastball over for a strike. So Ogilvie finds himself in a hole 0-2.
You know, the thing I've always said in any short series, if you got a speed club, to me, it always helps you for one reason. You can't get into a big slump with speed.
Curveball, a big hop, a bad hop, but Fernandez stays with it, throws to LaPointe, who dropped the ball crossing the bag. And Ogilvie will stay at first. It'll be an error charge to Dave LaPointe. Took a big hop at the last moment, and Hernandez stayed with it. Made a good play on that kangaroo bouncer, but then LaPointe dropped the throw coming over. So a one-out error puts Ogilvie at first and Don Money the batter. Money struck out and then doubled in the fifth inning on a ball that was hit off Willie McGee's glove and eventually led to the only Milwaukee run. LaPointe ready, delivers in the dirt. A good save by Darryl Porter. He gives it that Toulouse-Lautrec trot on his knees behind the plate.
You're not kidding. It was a great stop, though.
1-0 the count. Charlie Moore in the on-deck circle. Dave LaPointe takes a little walk on the grass behind the mound. Now Dave slowly makes his way up on top of the hill. 1-0 to Don Money, the designated hitter. 5-1 St. Louis in the seventh. The Cardinals have been leading since the first inning. The 1-0 pitch to Money, taken on the inside corner for a strike. 1-1. Cardinals scored one in the first, three in the second. The Brewers got one in the fifth, and the Cardinals picked up another in the sixth. 5-1 St. Louis. Fastball is hit up along third base foul. Fielded there by Harry Warner in the count 1-2. LaPointe backed up by Doug Baer down in the St. Louis bullpen. And a record crowd, a little impatient now, 56,560. But they have seen Milwaukee sputter. Now the 1-2 pitch to Don Money, fisted into right field, a base hit, just a blooper, and going to second and holding is Ogilvie. So an error followed by a bloop single to right. Money was hit right on the hands, cracked the bat, and got a dunker into right. And so Charlie Moore coming up with two on and one out. So Don Money is 2-for-3 today. Charlie Moore flied to center and singled. Moore the batter with Gantner on deck. You know, it's funny, habit, of course, all the years of doing National League. I find myself looking in the dugout for a pinch hitter for the pitcher. Every time I get down around number 8, I'm like, who's... And then I say, whoops. So here's Charlie Moore, 1-for-2. Two on, one out on the 7th, 5-1 Cardinals. LaPointe facing another challenge now. The left-hander delivers, swung on, and missed at the plate.
You have to understand, Benny, over here, we don't want to put too much burden on us guys because, you know, we just take it easy. So us managers in the American League, we just sit there and let the big guy go up and hammer.
Let's go and hammer. Well, we'll see about more hammering. 0-1 to Charlie. Jim Gantner on deck. For LaPointe, he had trouble in the fourth, in the fifth, and now here in the seventh. And, of course, his own error started his problem. 0-1 to Charlie Moore. LaPointe at the belt. The left-hander fires, swung on and missed. Do you think Charlie Moore's pressing a little bit, or is that just the way he swings all the time?
Well, they're keeping the ball in, but they're keeping the belt down. They're not getting the ball up. Charlie's an extremely good high ball hitter.
0-2 the count to Charlie Moore. The Brewers have not left many men on base. They haven't had many get on. and they have hit into two double plays. They've only left three men on base. So they have two on with one out. 0-2 the count to Charlie Moore, and the left hand hitting Jim Gantner on deck. Strike two pitch on the way. Fastball lifted to shortstop, and the infield fly rule is called as Ozzie Smith backs out and handles it. So they kept the ball down, and Charlie finally lifted it and just popped it up.
I think the one thing, like you said, the Cardinal people have really done, they have really gotten to their pitchers about making pitches, and I think you have to give Porter a lot of credit for this.
And the batter now, Jim Gantner. Now, I guess we give Darryl Porter a lot of credit except for the two fastballs to Ted Simmons in St. Louis.
Yeah, but those two, he hasn't been getting them back no more since. Why'd he put a stop to that?
Yeah, fool me once, not twice. All right, Jim Gantner, grounded to third, hit into a double play. The left-hand hitting second baseman swings and strokes it into right center field. That's going to fall for a base hit. In comes Ogilvy. Going to third is money on a double by Gantner. 5-2 St. Louis. Whitey Herzog making his way to the mound. Paul Molitor will be the batter with runners at second and third and two out. And, of course, a base hit now, and the Brewers are back in the ballgame. And Herzog looks like he's going to make a pitching change. He has Bear, and he's had Bear warming up for quite some time. And Molitor, right-hand batter. So in the inning, with one out, he had the error by LaPointe. Then the single by Money, which was just a broken bat blooper. And after Moore popped up, the double to right center by Gantner. And that will do it for Dave LaPointe. So LaPointe goes 6 2/3 innings. As far as the runs are concerned, they are unearned. But they still chase him. And while Doug Bear is warming up, let's pause for this.
WMAQ.
Before you look under the hood of a new car, look at how the hood fits. If you look at a Honda, you'll see the hood, doors, trunk, and hatch fit the body with close tolerances. That's Honda quality. And that's one reason why Hondas have traditionally retained a high resale value among the best in the industry. You only have to look at how the hood fits to understand that.
Miss it? You don't have to. You can strike two. Go bowling. Bowling, where strikes mean action and the action doesn't quit. So get out now, bring the whole gang, and show them all how much fun a strike can be. Go bowling. Lanes are available right now. National Bowling Council, Washington, D.C.
Doug Bear, the right-hander who was 5-3 during the year, will come in and pick up for Dave LaPointe. Bear, charged with the responsibility of getting Paul Molitor, with runners at second and third and two out. The Cardinal lead is now 5-2. And, of course, for Molitor, a base hit would really bring this place alive. Robin Yount is on deck. You want to refresh our memory about Doug Bear?
Doug Bear, Vinny, is a very good fastball and an excellent breaking ball. And his only problem has ever been that he can get himself in a little trouble every now and then with his control. But other than that, he's got outstanding stuff.
And he has first base open as Paul Molitor comes up. Down in the bullpen, Jeff Lottie, the right-hander, John Martin, the left-hander. And Jim Cott now gets up. They'll make it Cott instead of Martin. Paul Molitor, 0-3, with runners at second and third. Bear from a stretch, delivers high. Ball one. Molitor grounded to third, struck out, and flied to center. This is the closest look at this game the Brewers have had. 1-0, the count to Paul Molitor. Money down the line from third, Gantner away from second. The 1-0 pitch, a strike, and the count 1-1. Molitor wanted to go after it and then held up. Doug Bear from Defiance, Ohio. One year, I think he had 20-some-odd saves. Over
an outstanding year in 78.
The 1-1 pitch on the way in the dirt. A good save by Darryl Porter. 2-1. Doug Bear has been in two games and worked two innings prior to today, has not allowed a run. The 2-1 pitch to Molitor, taken low, ball three. Do you think they'll tear this place apart if Robin Young comes up with the bases loaded?
Well, I tell you what, he won't get a chance to, you know, to come up if he gets a fastball over here 3-1 unless he gets a base hit, because he'll be swinging.
And now the crowd on its feet, trying to cheer Molitor and distract Bear. The 3-1 pitch, very high, and the bases are loaded for Robin Young.
That's the thing, Benny, right there, that gets Dougie in trouble every now and then. He'll get wild. When he gets wild, well, he gets wild high. Now, with Robin Young, it's all right to get wild high if you get in, but don't get wild high away, because he hits the ball right out of here in right center.
So the bases are loaded with two out, a run over in the seventh inning. Cardinals 5, Milwaukee 2. Don Money is at third. Jim Gantner is at second. And Paul Molitor is at first. Yount had an infield single in the first inning. Twice hit back to the box. In the sixth inning, he hit it very hard, and LaPointe made an excellent defensive play. Bear delivers a high fly ball, slicing foul down the right field line and back in the lower deck. And you said it. He got the ball up and away, and he almost hit it into the right field seat.
Then he gets this ball up and away from him, he'll hit it right out in that bullpen when them Cardinals are warming up, too. You have to keep the ball down when you go away. You have to keep it up when you come in. If you don't, this young man can really hurt you.
Well, he hit 425 with runners in scoring position this year. So Robin Yount with two out and the bases loaded. The strike one pitch is a little high, and it's one ball and one strike. In the inning, with LaPointe pitching, one out, LaPointe dropped Hernandez's throw for an error. Money, a broken bat single to right. Moore popped up, but Gantman doubled in one, and that brought in Bear, who has just walked Molitor. The pitch high again, very high. Ball two. Two and one.
You know, at this point in the ballgame, Benny, it's really been both sides giving each other the runs. There hasn't been a case where they have really earned the runs to each club themselves.
And now Hub Kittle goes jogging out to the mound to talk to Doug Bear. So with the bases loaded and two out, Cardinals 5, Milwaukee 2. Robin Yount the hitter, 2-1 the count. And on deck, Cecil Cooper. Jim Cott and Jeff Lottie throwing in the bullpen. And the plate umpire, Dave Phillips, now going out to try and speed things along. Kittle, a little pep talk to Bear, and now Hub turns and jogs back towards the Cardinal dugout. Two and one, the count to Robin Yount. And now we've got the noise that Milwaukee is famous for. Bear out of a stretch. The 2-1 pitch. Yount checks his swing and hits it into right field. Base hit. In comes Money. In comes Gantner. Over to third goes Molitor. 5-4 St. Louis. A great swing by Robin Yount. It was a half swing, and he checked it, almost froze over the plate, but it went drilling into right field for two RBIs.
The guys called that, excuse me, mother, I didn't mean to swing.
Oops. But he has oops Milwaukee right back into the ball game. Robin Yount, a single to right to drive in two. It is now Cardinals 5, Milwaukee 4. The Cardinals 5 runs, 7 hits. And the Brewers coming back in this inning, all because of the error by Dave LaPointe. If he holds on to Hernandez's throw, the inning is over.
You know, Benny, but it's been that way, really, in this whole series, even the 10-0 ball game in St. Louis to start. It's kind of been a thing where both sides have made big mistakes that have allowed clubs to go ahead and score runs that shouldn't be scored.
Would you think that maybe it's part of being in the World Series?
I think it's part of being in the World Series. I think it's partly from playing in strange parks, whether it's AstroTurf or a grass field like this, you're in a strange environment. Plus, I think it's sometimes the case of where you want to do so good so badly that you're not playing your natural game.
Well, Jim Cott, the 43-year-old left-hander, is called in, and he has a gigantic responsibility. It is simply this. Get Cecil Cooper. There are runners at first and third, two out in the seventh. The Brewers are now revitalized, It's Cardinals 5 and the Brewers 4. And while Jim Cott is warming up, let's pause for this.
WMAQ.
Mr. Ballone?
Yes, but...
Pearl's party planning. We got your order for petunias, orchids, assorted violins.
It's assorted violets.
Oh. Hold the violins, fellas. Pearl has terrible handwriting.
Well, these flowers were for my wedding reception.
So?
That was 2 weeks ago.
Well, it's our delivery truck. Broke down. Just got a fix. Sign here, please.
Hey, don't you know about Jartran?
Sure. Hey, Ralph, got any more of those night-blooming Jartrans back there?
No. Jartran Truck Rental. Oh. It's a company that rents trucks and trailers and vans just the right size for your needs.
What do you want these garden hoses?
I asked for roses, not hoses.
Boy, Pearl has terrible handwriting.
Well, she won't have a business if she doesn't find out about Jartran Truck Rental.
You know, Jartran makes sense in today's economy. We can rent trucks just for our busy season. That month when everybody gets married?
June.
No, Pearl. Pearl's party planning.
Oh, brother.
Hey, what should I do with these musicians I brought over?
I didn't order musicians.
You sure did. Look right here, an assortment of jasmine.
That's jasmine. It's a flower.
I gotta talk to Pearl about...
For a limited time, any Jartran truck is just $29.90 a day for local rentals, Monday through Thursday. Restrictions apply, so ask for details.
Jim Cott, who was 5-3 during the regular year, picking up. Cott is in his fourth game in this World Series. He has worked 2 1/3 innings and has not allowed an earned run. In going back through the series, Cott relieved Force in the first game. Cott relieved Stuper in the second game. Cott relieved Andujar last night. And Cott trying to bail out the Cardinals now, because Doug Baer pitched to two batters, walked Molitor, and then gave up that check swing single to right by Robin Yount. So the Brewers have runners at first and third, and Cecil Cooper the hitter. And the ball game on the line. Cott, who has been working on a sidearm pitch this year, and we certainly would expect him to be doing a little of that with Cecil Cooper. Jim Cott pawing at the dirt in front of the rubber. Now puts that left foot on the rubber and looks into Darryl Porter. Molitor at third, Yount at first, and the pitch outside. Ball one. On deck is Ted Simmons. Cooper lined into a double play, had an infield single and flied to right. Cott out of a stretch. And the 1-0 pitch. Coop runs up as if to bunt and takes high. Ball two. Does he bunt much?
I've never seen him bunt much, but twice in the series now. He did it second time up today, and now he's faking like he's going to bunt again.
Two balls and no strikes. The count is Cecil Cooper. Robin Yount at first, held on by Hernandez. Molitor down the line from third. The 2-0 sidearmer is a high chopper, and it is what? Fair or foul? Foul. The first base umpire never called it.
Well, on that play there, Vinny, in all fairness to Sash Davis, the home plate umpire is supposed to pick that call up until it gets to the bag. And he got that ball in front of the bag.
And Dave Phillips ran down the first base foul line to make sure he had a good angle. And then you could have counted to about 5 or 6. And then he indicated foul ball. Hernandez had a leap high in the air before bringing the ball down. And Cooper, trying to help the first base umpire, was pointing. It was foul. It was foul. And then the plate umpire agreed with him. Okay, Coop back up, 2-1. Cott ready, side armor, ground ball, off the glove of Obergefell. Tied up ball game, stopping at second is Yount. Cooper banged one wide of third. Obergefell got his glove on the ball but couldn't hold it. It squirted away for an infield single as Obergefell had his nose in the dirt. Molitor scored to tie it up, and Robin Yount is at second. 5-5 in the seventh inning. And Porter out to the mound to talk to Cott, and Ted Simmons the batter. So Cooper twice going the other way. Single to short and now singles to third. That run brought in by Molitor belongs to Baer. And Yount at second is also Baer's responsibility. The pitch to Simmons, low, ball one.
That error by LaPointe now really just makes you, it's got to make a manager sick, and I know it makes all the Cardinal players, especially LaPointe.
Four runs here in the seventh inning, all unearned, all because Dave LaPointe dropped the throw by Hernandez. Simmons swings and doesn't get a breaking ball. In the count, 1-1. In the inning with one out, the error, file a point. Then a single by Money broke his bat. Pop to short, the double by Gantner, and that was all for LaPointe. The walk to Molitor and the single by Yount against Bear. The pitch in the dirt gets behind Porter, and they each go 90 feet. Cooper to second, Yount to third. Wild pitch.
Benny, I hope they don't use this picture of this game during the winter. I hope they don't send this out to the kids to tell them how to play.
What an inning. Ted Simmons is the ninth man to come to the plate here at County Stadium. This record crowd, delirious. And here comes Whitey Herzog. First base open, and then you have Gorman Thomas. Boy, would that be a spot to bring a kid like Lottie in here with the bases loaded and pitch to Gorman Thomas?
Oh. Well, Benny, I tell you what, that's why I really believe Whitey's done a tremendous job. He has done, I think, all year. He has used these people in situations, and he's going that way, and the kids know that he has confidence in them.
Well, he's talking to Jim Cott right now, but and he's going to bring Jeff Lott. What's that old comics line, I wouldn't give this spot to a leopard?
Well, that's why Whitey, to me, he puts that confidence in these kids, and they believe they can do it.
Now, this is a scoring point for those of you who really keep a close tab on a game. Jim Cott leaves with a two-ball count on Simmons. Should Simmons walk, even though Lottie would walk Simmons, the walk would belong to Cott. So then if Simmons eventually scored, the run would belong to Cott. As of the moment, in this tied-up game, the pitchers of record, Doug Bear, who could lose it, and Jim Slayton, who could win it. But, of course, the ballgame is tied 5-5. Jeff Lottie jogging in from the bullpen. And while Jeff Lottie is warming up, let's pause for this.
WMAQ. NFL, the World Series, NCAA basketball, the big events you want to follow are here with CBS Radio Sports live coverage all year long. And all week, you want to keep up with your favorite sports. Here's how to do it Monday through Friday.
Good morning, everybody. Jim Kelly with the Sports World Roundup on the CBS
and early morning recap of competition, highlights, scores, and player comments.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Brent Musburger with Sports Time.
A look ahead to future events, plus Brent's views and interviews.
Hi, everyone. I'm Per Gowdy on sports.
A profile, an interview, a candid comment on a hot sports issue, and Saturday and Sunday, you'll hear from
Bill Schweitzer, Sports Time.
Top of the morning broadcast to start off each sports day, and then all day and night, Saturday and Sunday.
I'm Win Elliott.
I'm Jim Hunter.
Howard Davis. Sports Central USA covers what's happening as it happens. 18 separate weekend editions. Follow your favorite sports with CBS Radio's Jim Kelly, Brent Musburger, Kirk Gowdy, Win Elliott, Howard David, and Jim Hunter every day of the year on most of these CBS Radio Network stations. Hear it here.
Jeff Lottie taking his 8 warm-up tosses. We can use the time. Let's pause 5 seconds for stations to identify themselves.
It's Jimmy Pearsall after the game on 67 WMAQ Chicago.
WMAQ.
Jeff Lottie tuning up. He was acquired from Cincinnati in a deal that sent Bob Shirley to Ohio. And he was outrighted to Louisville when he was acquired. However, he still worked in 21 games for the Cardinals with their AAA affiliate. Called up to St. Louis in June, and he provided solid relief help. Even got a start against Montreal. Picked up his first major league win. So Jeff Lottie, L-A-H-T-I, will be pitching to Ted Simmons, but the chances certainly are that they will put Simmons on with first base open and then have him go after Gorman Thomas.
Well, then he's going to do one of two things. Either he's going to put him on directly, or he's going to let him go ahead and throw two bad breaking balls. No, he's going to go ahead and put him on.
Lottie is 26 years old. He's out of Oregon. And he will walk Simmons, but again, remember now, that walk is charged to Cott. In a moment, Gorman Thomas coming up with the bases loaded in a 5-5 tie. 4 unearned runs for the Brewers. They'll take them. Gorman Thomas flied to center, came up with 2 on and 1 out in the 4th inning and fouled out. And led off this inning by fouling out. So Gorman Thomas, with his second at-bat in the inning, he is 0 for 3, hitting only 148. So Jeff Lottie looks down to get a sign. And after showing some troubles in reading the sign, Darryl Porter spots it and goes running out to talk to him. So Ted Simmons is at first. Cecil Cooper is at second. Robin Yount at third. A 5-5 tie. The Cardinals led 4-0, 4-1, 5-1, and now 5-5. Lottie will pitch out of a stretch. The infield is back, and Gorman Thomas waiting. The right-hander set at the belt delivers, and it's high. Ball one. Oh, what a pressure spot.
About as tight as you can get, Ben.
Oh. And especially for the visiting pitcher against a home run hitter and here in Milwaukee. 1-0 to Gorman Thomas. Yount down the line from third. Cooper a cautious lead at second. Simmons a big lead at first. The 1-0 pitch. Thomas takes a strike in the count 1-1. Tommy Herr is way over to the right to fill up the middle. Keith Hernandez is almost all alone between first and second. Thomas has two hits in 14 at-bats in the series, one RBI. Lottie ready in the 1-1 pitch, taken for a strike, 1-2, buzzed the outside corner. Lottie behind the rubber, heaves a little sigh. Boy, the mouth gets dry about this stage, Spark.
Well, right here, you get about as dry as you can get.
Thomas backs out. He's not quite ready. And the tension mounts and the crowd going wild. 5-5 in the seventh inning. And again, Thomas not ready. Backs out. Simmons, Cooper, and Yount taking their leads. And again, Porter said, I want to go out and talk to my man.
Ben, he's made two pitches on Thomas. As good a pitch you can make right on the outside corner. As long as he stays out there from the corner out on this pitch, he'll be all right. If he gets that ball inside here, he's in trouble.
All right, Darryl Porter getting behind the plate, but taking his time. And Jeff Lottie kind of twisting in the wind out there. The fourth Cardinal pitcher, LaPointe, Bear, Cott, and now Lottie. And all four making an appearance here in the seventh inning. The 1-2 pitch to Thomas, swung on and driven into left center. Base hit. In comes Yount. In comes Cooper. Going to third is Simmons. Into second goes Gorman Thomas. 7-5 Milwaukee.
There's a case, Vinny. He made two great pitches. Now he throws a slider and he gets the slider. Get up and right over the middle of the plate. And that's where you say, that's the thing about that experience, boy. It just gets you where you just don't make that third pitch when you have to make it.
And they are wild in Milwaukee. As Gorman Thomas doubles home two to break the tie. First base open. Ben Ogilvy will get the intentional walk. And there's ball one to Ben. Will be the 11th man to come to the plate here in the eighth inning. Yount, who scored, belonged to Bear. Cooper, who scored, belonged to Cott. So four runs charged to LaPointe. Bear is charged with two, Cott with one. And for the second time in the inning, the bases are loaded and Don Money, who broke his bat and got a bloop single to right, his first time up in the inning, is coming up. Money is 2-for-3.
Go back to that error by LaPointe, Vinny, and it just shows you when you got a ball club that can hit like Milwaukee and break things open, you give them the opportunity, and they've scored six runs.
Six unearned runs. Simmons at third. Thomas at second. Ogilvy at first. And Don Money at the plate against Jeff Lottie. Lottie on the rubber. And again, Porter going out to him. The guy who invented what is the old cliche now about it only takes one. This was a perfect case the way he pitched to Gorman Thomas. Two great strikes on the outside corner, but Thomas had one more card to play, and no pun intended there. So Don Money with the bases loaded and two out. Lottie delivers, and it's a chopper foul off to the left of the plate, and the count 0-1.
Benny, what'd Yogi say? He says it's not over till it's over.
0-1 the count. Boy, you talk about a ball club getting off the floor. It wasn't Sudsville, it was Dudsville here. It was 5-1 in favor of St. Louis.
But Benny, they didn't get off the floor. LaPointe drops a ball at first base. It's an automatic out. You let them off the floor, and you can't let good ball clubs off the floor.
And now, of course, they're really trying to run away with it. The strike one pitch to Money is low, 1-1. One ball and one strike to Don Money, the 12th man. And as far as the Cardinals are concerned, the Dirty Dozen. The 1-1 pitch, Money takes a strike. 1-2, but that was the count on Gorman Thomas before he doubled. 1-2. Six unearned runs come pouring across in the seventh inning, and Milwaukee leading the Cardinals 7-5. Jeff Lottie out of a stretch, and the 1-2 pitch to Money is strung on and hit to left field, but Lonnie Smith is there to grab it for the out. And at the end of seven, they're going wild in Milwaukee. Milwaukee 7 and St. Louis 5.
After the game, it's Jimmy Pearsall on WMAQ.
Central Tire keeps you on the road. Central Tire has brand names you know.
Like Michelin, who invites you to the grand opening of Central Tire's fourth location on Chicago's far south side. Along with savings up to 40% off on Michelin tires, Central Tire has a special World Series offer. The first 25 customers who buy a set of four Michelin tires at each Central Tire location receives a free Michelin winter jacket. Save up to 40% off on Michelin tires all this week at Central Tire. All tire purchases include free balancing and free mounting. Michelin, the quality radial tire designed to deliver long mileage and precise handling. Central Tire, with their newest Michelin location just off the Calumet Expressway on Doty at 115th Street.
As we go to the eighth inning here at County Stadium in Milwaukee, and the Brewers down 5-1, parlayed the error by Dave LaPointe into a six-run seventh inning. And the Brewers taking the field to start the eighth inning, leading 7-5. Six runs, five hits, and an error in the seventh inning. And that's the most runs in an inning in the World Series since the Baltimore Orioles scored six against Pittsburgh at Pittsburgh in Game 4 of the 1979 World Series. In the eighth inning for the Cardinals, Darryl Porter, followed by Lonnie Smith, and then Dane Orr. What a magnificent game. I don't just mean that this is. What a magnificent creation baseball is.
It's unbelievable because I don't care how smooth it looks like it's going, how good your club looks like you're playing. Just 1 minute passes and the whole thing just shut down.
And I would think that Dave LaPointe will see himself dropping that throw by Keith Hernandez in the seventh inning for a long, long time. But it's onward. Never mind backwards. And Darryl Porter, single to center, hit back to the box and struck out. Darryl is 1-for-3. 7 runs, 10 hits for Milwaukee. 5 runs, 7 hits, and 1 error for the Cardinals. The Brewers have committed 2 errors. And Slayton delivers high, ball one. You know what I was just thinking? If we're ever going to see Raleigh Fingers, this might be the time. They're ahead.
I don't believe we're ever going to see Raleigh Fingers, Ben.
One ball and no strikes. The count of Darryl Porter. The catcher looks and pays a strike for the privilege in the count 1-1. One ball, one strike to Darryl Porter in the eighth inning, 7-5, Milwaukee. Now the 1-1 pitch on the way. Over for a strike. 1-2. And who do you think is just starting to throw in the Milwaukee bullpen?
Raleigh Fingers, but I still don't believe you're going to see him, Benny.
Okay. 1-2 the count. Slayton comes back. Breaking ball down and away. Ball two. 2-2. Porter, Lonnie Smith, and Orge. Darryl Porter hitting .357 in the series with 5 hits and 2 RBIs. A 2-2 pitch. Darryl takes outside. Ball three. Bob McClure, the only left-hander available for Harvey Keene, is down in the pen with Raleigh Fingers. 3-2 to Darryl Porter. And Slayton is very high. Ball four. Slayton's second walk. Lonnie Smith hit into a force play, lined back to the box, and doubled to left and scored a run. So Lonnie is one for three. Tomorrow, game five, Mike Caldwell and Bob Forsch, a rematch at 4:35 p.m. Eastern Time. Lonnie Smith waiting, and Slayton delivers. Lonnie takes a strike inside part of the plate. 0-1. No balls, one strike to Lonnie. On deck, the left-hand hitting Dane Orge, then Willie McGee. Strike one pitch on the way. Lonnie takes very high. One ball, one strike. Does Slayton have reasonably good control?
Jimmy will get wild. When he gets wild, he gets wild high, and that's where he's been so far this inning.
Boy, you sure called it on Doug Baer. 1-1 to count. Slayton at the belt. The 1-1 pitch on the way. Half swing foul back to the screen. Lonnie Smith really tied up in knots, fooled on that pitch. It's another amazing thing. Robin Yount, a check swing single to right for two RBIs. Don Money, a broken bat single to right. There's no way to defense those things. Lonnie Smith with a count 1-2. Slayton checking Ted Simmons. Now Jim straightens up. A look over at first. The right hander already comes to the hitter, and Lonnie chased it and struck out. He didn't have good swings at all.
You know, Benny, other than he's had a couple of doubles, he had, well, in fact, two doubles and a triple, but other than those times at bat, he's had bad swings so far in this series.
Yeah, he was really cheated there. He had two bad swings. So Lonnie Smith strikes out, and here is Dane Orge. Fly to center, pop to short, and then Orge doubled to right in the sixth inning to drive in Lonnie Smith. Darryl Porter at first, held on by Cecil Cooper. Big hole on the right side, and he strokes it into right center field for a base hit. Gorman Thomas over to cut it off, and going to third is Porter. So the Cardinals try to come back. First and third, one out, and Willie McGee the batter. You know, I look at Dane Orge occasionally, sporadically during the year, and I keep thinking, you know, if he could do more things than just swing the bat, he'd be quite a player.
Yeah, he's a fine-looking hitter. I've seen him a lot in the spring, and he's always swung the bat good in spring training, only he showed me more power in the spring. I don't know. I guess during spring training, he's real strong at that time.
He just doesn't run too well. David Green will now run for him. So David Green running for Orge. And now Harvey Keene slowly going out to the mound. Willie McGee will be the batter. And we'll see if Harvey is going to go to the pen. He looks out there. Remember we told you Bob McClure was out there. Raleigh Fingers was playing catch. And if you bring in the left-hander and Keene gestures with his left hand, he wants McClure. And, of course, McClure gives you two breaks. He holds that runner on at first. And he will turn Willie McGee around to hit right-handed. Pete Ladd is now throwing, and apparently Spark, Raleigh Fingers, played catch and decided he couldn't cut it.
Sure, he just threw Benny and found out that, you know, he just couldn't do it.
So it's been Haas, Slayton, and now McClure. McClure, a very impressive-looking left-hander in the little bit that we saw of him. And he'll be going head-to-head with Willie McGee here in the eighth inning. So Slayton came in the sixth inning to pitch to McGee. Slayton worked the seventh, and he got one out in the eighth, so he worked a total of two innings. And now McClure will pick up. And while McClure is warming up, let's pause for this.
WMAQ. Weekends, there's a wealth of good listening on CBS Radio. Saturday, correspondent Fred Graham looks at the law and you, and Mike Wallace at Large talks with famous folks you'd like to know about. Lee Jordan's here in the spotlight with fascinating film reviews, and Steve Birnbaum takes you traveling to faraway places. Charles Carroll takes us down the byways on Dateline America, and we've got the golf, tennis, and outdoor spots. Then Sunday, there's more in store. Washington Watch with Bruce Morton and Steve Birnbaum's back traveling with more vacation advice.
Steve Scheuer's here with television watching, which is what to watch and what to watch out for in the TV week ahead. Then Mike Wallace is back with another intriguing profile. You get a top news story on Correspondence Corner, new editions of the golf, tennis, and outdoor spots. And to wrap it all up, there's Rob Armstrong with the World This Week. Plus, big sports doings, too, every weekend on CBS Radio. Hear it here.
Keep your dial set to CBS. Get ready. But here's Willie McGee. Single to left, grounded to short, fly to left. Darryl Porter down the line from third, and the runner David Green at first for Dane Orridge, representing the tying run. McClure looks at first, comes to the hitter. Good breaking ball for a strike. 0-1. Want to refresh our memory on McClure?
He's got a great move to first base. I call it very questionable, but he's got a great move.
What about his stuff?
He's got a good fastball and a good curve.
Well, McGee just saw the curve, 0-1. McClure decides he'll go to first base, sending David Green back to the bag. Milwaukee 7, Cardinals 5. Top of the eighth inning, one out. McClure out of a stretch. The left-hander's strike one pitch is instead that hesitation, kind of hang in the air and then go to first.
He hasn't given him a good one yet. I think he's a little worried that he might give the good one and have it called a balk.
And, of course, at third base, Darryl Porter could walk in. 0-1. McClure ready, looks, and the strike one pitch. McGee hits it by the mound, down to second. Gantner on the bag, doubles him at first. Jim Gantner takes the ball up the middle for a double play, and the Cardinals have their pin feathers jerked out of the eighth. And at the end of 7.5, Milwaukee 7 and the Cardinals 5.
WMAQ.
There's a big bad bungle in the jungle, and the pretty girl is running out of luck. Who are we gonna get to be a hero? There's only one. Frank Buck. CBS TV went out and got him. So action and adventure would survive. With a TV and a guide, you can spot him. It's Frank Buck in Bring Him Back Alive.
Tuesday at 8, 7, Central and Mountain on CBS TV. Frank Buck stops here.
You gotta reach deep inside.
We've all felt it.
Come on, bring out that pride.
The challenge to make every effort count in all we do to bring out the best.
Bring out your best. Bring out your best.
The challenge for us was to brew a light beer worthy of the king of beers. One with a clean, distinctive taste. Budweiser Light lived up to the challenge.
Bring out your best.
Budweiser Light.
Bring out your best.
Budweiser Light.
To brew Budweiser Light, it took time, patience, and a commitment to quality. But then, the best never comes easy. That's why there's nothing else like it. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Some final scores in football. Clemson 49, Duke 14, North Carolina 41, North Carolina State 9, Dartmouth 14, Harvard 12, Army 20, Princeton 14, Tennessee 27, Alabama 21 in the fourth quarter. And Notre Dame 10, Arizona nothing at the half. Charlie Moore, Jim Gantner, and Paul Molitor in the bottom of the eighth inning, 7-5 Milwaukee. As Willie McGee bangs into a double play to Jim Gantner.
I'd like to say I was right again, but I said he can't be doubled.
Well, it's the only way they could get him on that ground ball right at the bag. Charlie Moore takes a strike, 0-1. Moore flied to center, single to center, and popped to short. Jeff Lotte, the fourth Cardinal pitcher, delivers and another back to the box. Jeff picks it up, straightens up, and throws him out. One away. If you are not keeping score and you wonder about the Cardinals in the ninth inning, Ozzie Smith, Tommy Herr, and Ken Oberkfeld are due up. Jim Gantner grounded to third, hit into a double play, but then doubled in the seventh inning. He takes high, ball one. Gantner's double scored Ogilvy, sent Money to third, and the Brewers were off and running. The 1-0 pitch to Jim Gantner is swung on and fouled back out of play. 1-1. Gantner was 4 for 10 going into today's game, so 5 for 13 in the series, hitting .385. He has knocked in 3, scored 3. The 1-1 pitch to Jim. Left-hand hitter takes away. Ball 2, 2-1. 7 runs, 10 hits, 2 errors for Milwaukee, 5 runs, 8 hits, and 1 error for the Cardinals. The next pitch to Gantner is inside. 4 runs, 7 hits against LaPointe. 2 runs, 1 hit against Bear. And Doug could be the losing pitcher unless the Cardinals can rally in the ninth. Now the 3-1 pitch. Lottie, as Gantner backs out, so Lottie off the rubber. Now Jeff is ready. And the 3-1 pitch to Jim Gantner, line drive right at Ozzie Smith. So Gantner hits it hard, but at the shortstop, 2 down. And Paul Molitor will be the batter. Molitor grounded to third, struck out, fly to center and walk. Molitor hitting .385. On deck, Robin Yount. Lottie into the windup. Right-hander comes to his hitter, down and away. Ball one, 1-0. Molitor has 7 hits, including 1 RBI. And he is 0 for 3 with a walk. His walk in the seventh inning, he scored on the ball that went off Oberkfell's glove. The pitch, a strike, and the count 1-1. Lottie checking. Now the 1-1 pitch on the way, swung on and sliced foul down the right field line back in the lower deck in the count 1-2.
You know, Vinny, if Milwaukee wins this ballgame, what a change. Instead of the Cardinals being up 3-1, now they're 2-2, and now the power goes over to Milwaukee because they got Caldwell and Sutton lined right up.
Here's the 1-2 pitch on the way. Lottie delivers, swung on and fouled the other way outside of third. It's going to be something, all with the drop throw at first base. Everything has changed.
It's amazing how that could change. Instead of you having a 2-game lead, you're even. And, of course, this ballgame isn't over yet.
1-2 the count. Molitor waiting with Robin Yount on the on-deck circle. And the 1-2 pitch, it looked like a bad ball, but he went after it and fouled it away. It's somewhere up around his shoulders. 1-2 to Paul Molitor. 7-5 in favor of Milwaukee in the eighth. Lottie into the windup, and his 1-2 pitch is just outside. Ball two, 2-2. To repeat, Ozzie Smith, Tommy Herr, and Ken Obergfell due up for the Cardinals. Keith Hernandez would be the fourth hitter in the inning. The 2-2 pitch is lifted to left center field. Lonnie Smith started back. Now he has to come racing in to make the catch. He'll scare you a lot out there, but at least he caught up to it. And at the end of eight, Milwaukee 7 and the Cardinals 5.
WMAQ. Some of today's small cars have really brought the family closer together.
Timmy, kicking the back of Daddy's seat won't make the car go any faster.
Perhaps a little too close. That's one of the reasons why the Buick LeSabre has found its way into the hearts and garages of America. It has more than enough room for 6 with lots of trunk space for gear. So next time you take the family somewhere, think of taking a Buick LeSabre too. Because sometimes togetherness is better when everyone's a comfortable distance apart.
Hello?
Mom, guess what? Your little granddaughter had the starring role in her school play, The Princess and the Frog.
Princess and the Frog?
Yeah, we got it on her cassette recorder. Listen.
What does she play, the frog?
No.
Call me when you get a Quasar.
Depend on Quasar to capture that special moment. Each of Quasar's 14 different tape recorders and radio cassette recorders deliver quality sound wherever and whenever you want it.
Quasar.
For quality and dependability, shouldn't you have a Quasar?
Hi, I'm Rick Mundy. Playing high school sports is a great experience for me, almost as great as that playoff home run in 1981. Today, there are millions of high school students enjoying the valuable experience of playing high school sports. But without your support, high school sports programs will stop. Don't let that happen. Invest in America's greatest resource, our youth. Support your local high school sports programs, the other half of education. Baseball cares.
The preceding message was furnished by Major League Baseball.
Well, we've arrived at the ninth inning at County Stadium in Milwaukee. I'm Vin Scully, along with Sparky Anderson, the manager of the Detroit Tigers. It's been a rough and bumpy ride, but the Brewers are leading 7-5. Ozzie Smith, Tommy Herr, and Ken Obergefell against left-hander Bob McClure. When you turn Ozzie around, there's only a couple of points difference as a switch hitter, but he did hit better as a right-handed batter than left. And he's hitting right-handed against the left-handed McClure. Paul Molitor playing up inside the bag at third. McClure from a stretch delivers, and a slow breaking ball missed inside. Ball one, 1-0. So McClure, with the bases empty, still working from his stretch. And the 1-0 pitch to Ozzie Smith is a fastball for a strike, 1-1. Does McClure do that all year?
First time I've ever seen him. I guess everybody's going to copy Suter now. That's going to be the new fad.
Well, the big responsibility to keep Ozzie off the bases. He stole 25 out of 30 during the regular year. The 1-1 pitch on the way. McClure delivers high with his fastball. Ball two, 2-1. Ozzie backs out for the moment. Now checks back in again. And Bob McClure, the third Milwaukee pitcher, set at the belt in his 2-1 pitch. Fastball, and it's a one-hopper hit to Gantner. Jim picks it up and throws him out.
You know, Vinny, how would you like to be a club, though, like Milwaukee in a World Series? You got there because of certain people, especially for a big guy, Fingers. That's how you got there. And how would you like to be Harvey Keene sitting over there? It's like you don't have your cannon. You know, here you are.
Right, going to war with a broom instead of the cannon. And down 5-1 in this all-important fourth game. And turning it around to take a 7-5 lead into the ninth inning. Here is Tommy Herr, a switch hitter. He has to bat right-handed. And McClure delivers, and the fastball is low, ball one. By the way, we'd like to alert our stations that a local break is coming up after the third out. One ball and no strikes to Tommy Herr. On deck, Gene Tennis to hit for Obergefell. The 1-0 pitch, breaking ball, low and inside, ball two. Tommy Herr wearing a protective shin guard on his right leg, and if he were a right-handed batter, he wouldn't be in the big leagues. But he's a switch hitter. And apparently a quick bat left-handed, and he has fouled a lot of pitches off his shin guard, but only left-handed. The 2-0 pitch, a strike, 2-1. Saying there's no way he's going to foul a ball off his right shin as a right-handed batter and be in the big leagues if he had that slow a bat.
Well, no, that's that slow, he's got problems, man.
You're gone. 2-1 to Tommy Herr. McClure ready, delivers, fastball for a strike at the knees.
You're one of the guys you see there, that's our Judas Shag.
2-2 to Tommy Herr. McClure now takes a little walk on the grass behind the mound, gazing out towards the outfield. And this Milwaukee crowd getting up on its feet. With one out on the ninth, 7-5 Milwaukee, the 2-2 pitch. Curveball got him looking. Did he set him up?
You know, Benny, like you were saying, they were standing up. First time I seen him standing up with one out, I seen him with two all the time, but they're getting a little eager.
So with two out in the ninth inning, Gene Tennis will come up and bat for Ken Obergefell. Gene Tennis, right-hand hitter, who is 0-4 in the series. Don't forget tomorrow, Mike Caldwell, Bob Forsh, 4:35 p.m. Eastern Time. Two out, bases empty in the ninth. Milwaukee an out away from getting a split. And the pitch in the dirt, ball one. On deck, Keith Hernandez. Seven runs, 10 hits, 2 errors for Milwaukee. 5 runs, 8 hits, and 1 error for the Cardinals. Again, McClure taking a little walk out on the grass. Blows on his pitching hand and now gets up on top. Tennis waiting at the plate. One ball and no strikes. McClure delivers, fastball fouled away. Off to the right, out of play. And the count 1-1. A record crowd, 56,560. So the Cardinals take a 1-0 lead, a 4-0 lead, a 4-1 lead, a 5-1 lead, and then saw Milwaukee score 6 unearned runs in the 7th inning to turn it around 7-5. McClure's 1-1 pitch to Tennis. Change for a strike.
Great changeup. You know, he hasn't thrown all day, and he just drops it in.
What a great change he just threw. 1-2. And they are close to being delirious at County Stadium. Tennis pumping the wood back and forth. McClure out of a stretch. The 1-2 pitch. Curveball got him swinging. McClure, all he did was get Willie McGee to hit into a double play in the 8th and retire the side in order, striking out Herr and Tennis in the 9th. The totals for the Brewers, 7 runs, 10 hits, 2 errors. For the Cardinals, who have to feel they blew the game, 5 runs, 8 hits, 1 error. The winning pitcher is Jim Slayton, and the losing pitcher is Doug Baer. Let's give our stations a chance for a message, and we'll continue in just a moment.
WMAQ.
Central Tire keeps you on the road. Central Tire has brand names you know.
Like Michelin, who invites you to the grand opening of Central Tire's 4th and newest Chicago location on Chicago's South Side. Along with savings up to 40% off on Michelin tires at all 4 Central Tire locations, Central Tire has a special World Series offer. The first 25 customers who buy a set of 4 Michelin tires at any Central Tire location receives a free Michelin winter jacket. Save up to 40% on Michelin tires all this week during Central Tire's grand opening. All tires purchased include free mounting and free balancing. Visa and MasterCharge accepted. Central Tire, now with 4 Chicagoland locations, including 18th and Indiana, Cottage Grove near Cermak, Roosevelt Road near Austin in Cicero, and their newest Michelin location just off Calumet Expressway on Doty between 115th and 130th Street exits. For more details, see Central Tire's ad in Thursday Sun Times.
We're always around.
WMAQ.
You know, down through the years, Sparky, and looking over World Series games, if there be such a thing as a pivotal game, one game that seems to always affect the World Series, it is the 4th game.
Has to be, Ben, because normally with two great clubs, I don't care, American National League, you're always going to be basically even. So it's got to be 2-1, and you know, unless it's a freak thing. So you're 2-1. Now you win that, you're 3-1. They got to come and get you for 3 straight days. All you have to do is sit there and have the ball bounce for you one good day. Today was the key game. And really, the Cardinals had it right there. LaPointe just had a routine ball. He took his eye off of the first base and dropped it.
Had the Cardinals held on to any portion of a 5-1 lead, I really had the feeling at that stage they were going to win it tomorrow and that would be the end of the World Series.
I had the same feeling, Ben, because I think the 3-1, it really put them in a very confident mood, a very cocky mood, where they could gamble and do things and run. But now it changed it. Now you got Mr. Caldwell, who pitched a great game over there the first game. He's going tomorrow. If you win or lose tomorrow, you're going to play again, and you've got Sutton backing him up. So now Milwaukee has 2 fine pitchers going.
Now here's how baseball is so maddeningly crazy if you try to really study it out. In the 7th inning, after Thomas fouled out, Ben Ogilvie hit a ground ball to Keith Hernandez. The first thing that happened, the ball took a kangaroo bounce. It took a bad hop. That meant Hernandez could not just run it to the bag, which he probably would have done. Because of that high hop, he had to throw the ball to Dave LaPointe, who otherwise wouldn't have been involved. And LaPointe drops the ball, and it turns into a 6-run inning. All because of, really, the bad hop.
Bad hop, and then how about the play with Cooper up first and third, 5-4. He hits a high hopper towards first. It is just foul by an inch. So it's a game of inches, but that's the reason, Benny. These are just 2 fine baseball teams. One mistake's going to let the other one in the door.
And Don Money, in that 7th inning, came up and broke his bat and singled to right. Came up a second time in the 7th inning with the bases loaded, hit the ball hard, but for an out right at Lonnie Smith.
Robin Yount tried to get out of the way, check swing the ball, hits the ball in the right field, scores 2 runs. So, you know, again, you can go on and on, but to me, these are 2 fine baseball teams. I think myself it's going 7. I felt that at the start, but I don't know. If you keep making some of the mistakes we're making, I don't know.
You know, you see a game like today, and you realize the wear and tear on a manager. And I say this in all honesty. You wonder sometimes how every one of you doesn't have high blood pressure and an ulcer.
Well, we mostly do. I'll say this. I have an ulcer. I think most of the guys do. Most of us have high blood pressure. I've missed that one. I've been very lucky. But well, the guy I really feel sorry for is Harvey King. He's sitting over there. He don't have his ace. Now, the other people have been doing good. But he deserves to come into the World Series and have the guy to match up to Suter. And that's Fingers. Harvey deserves that coming into something like this.
You have felt in your heart that we would not see Raleigh Fingers. I thought, well, if we're going to see him, it would be today when they got the 7-5 lead. And at least we did see him get up and try to warm up. But evidently, after trying to warm up twice, if they can't use him today, I guess we won't see him.
It's too much. I mean, next year is another big year for this ball club. They can't afford to take a chance. Unless he's totally healthy, Raleigh Fingers will not walk out in the 82 World Series.
Well, we'll send it down to the field for some post-game interviews with Win Elliott in 60 seconds. But right now, let's pause for this word.
After the game, it's Jimmy Pearsall on WMAQ.
I'm George Allen. Back in Chicago to start my football career over again as owner and coach of Chicago Blitz in the new United States Football League. I have found creating a new professional team my biggest challenge. Chicago is a great city, and it was my home for 8 years. In 63, I helped bring a championship to this city. Now I intend to work longer and harder to bring another winner. We want the Blitz to be a team the people of Chicago can be proud of. Already, we have signed 5 named players, including Greg Landry and Tim Reitman, an All-American. This is how we will build the Chicago Blitz, with a combination of veteran players and young stars. But as we build our team into a winner, we need your help. The football fans of Chicago. Our home will be Chicago's Soldier Field, and good midfield tickets are available. Just call 670-0100 or 670-USFL and place your order now. WMAQ.
And so they are even. 4 games of this 1982 World Series have been played, and Milwaukee down 2-1 and down 5-1 in the game. Ford 6 across in the 7th and win it 7-5. Reminder tomorrow, 4:35 Eastern Time for Game 5 with Bob Forsh and Mike Caldwell. Now, for Sparky Anderson, this is Vin Scully. We'll be talking to you tomorrow, and let's go down to the field. Take it away, Win Elliott.
Okay, Vin, and right here I have a young man. I guess this has to be what in your career, Bob McClure?
Well, I think today was the biggest high I've had in baseball, for sure.
I didn't even see the last the top of the ninth inning, because we have to hide in the runway. They won't let us out on the field. Do you remember exactly the first batter up you faced? Ozzie Smith.
Right. I just tried to stay ahead of him, and I knew he may push a bunt down the first base line, so I went from the stretch instead of from the windup, because I fall over a lot more from the windup. So I just wanted to get ahead, get the first guy out, and then go on from there.
And, of course, the crowd is roaring like it. Do you hear them?
Well, you hear more just of a buzz. You know, you're concentrating so hard, you really don't hear any one thing.
What's this bit about it? There is no such thing as pressure. Pressure is something you put on yourself.
Well, I believe that so, and, I think my faith has helped me because I leave all the pressure to the Lord, you know, and I just go out there and do the best I can and go as hard as I can. And if you give it 100% and you walk off that mound and you go sit down, you gave it 100% and you don't look back.
So what were you thinking about when Tommy Herr comes up? He's the second best.
Well, the same thing. Just get ahead of them and have them hit your best pitch. Mm-hmm. And that's what I tried to do.
And then Obergefell, who's been very pesky in this series, he scored the first run, his base on balls, he stole second, he got the second run.
Well, I think Gene Tennis hit for
Did he? Well, I tell you, I was down in the dugout. I couldn't see anything.
Well, he's a dead fastball hitter, and what I wanted to do was try and stay away from him, keep the ball down, and if I get ahead of him, then go with the slider.
And all I can hear is, I can see your flash. You do a Louis Tiant in your pitching, don't you?
Well, not exactly. I just try, it's the most comfortable motion for me, and Louis and Gene Garber are my two favorite pitchers, and it felt so comfortable for me to do, so I just started doing it, and I've been doing it for the whole year now.
Well, for those of you, the folks who haven't seen you, what we mean by that is you practically turn your back on the batter, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Well, what is this bit about you always got to keep your eye on the ball?
Well, you mean the eye on home plate?
Yeah.
I picked the mound up, you know, as soon as I turn around. So it's a little deceptive, I think, for the hitters. And I think pitching is a lot of it is deception.
Mm-hmm.
There's some guys that throw 100 miles an hour, like Nolan Ryan or someone like that, and they don't need that. But someone like me who throws, you know, anywhere from 85 to 90, I could use a deception. And I've seen Gene Garber go out there, throw changeup after changeup and get him out because of his motion.
How about, when you say 85 to 90, of course, you mean 85 to 90 what?
Miles per hour.
Yeah. How much do you weigh?
About 174.
Gee, I'm bigger and fatter. Bob was magnificent. You have put the bloom back in the cheeks here in Milwaukee. You've now squared the series at 2-2. And so you look forward tomorrow. Well, as you just said, you don't really worry.
No, I don't. Like I said, I praise the Lord, you know, because he takes all the pressure. He's got the pressure. I don't. Look at all those people in Cambodia. They got the pressure.
Yeah. You know what?
Yeah.
You're right.
I appreciate you asking me out here, Wayne. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure.
All right.
Bob McClure. And as you have heard, a very confident young man, confident in the best possible way. Isn't it nice? Well, the last 2 days, we've had such humble and deserving guys who've been the key people in these games. Well, look, we're going to give our stations a chance for a message. Let's pause for this word.
Before winter weather stops your car cold, True Value Hardware Stores want to offer a winter driving tip. Hi, Pat Summerall suggesting you replace your old spark plugs now with new Champion Copper Plus spark plugs. They'll give more than twice the fouling protection of other major brands to help prevent stalling, misfiring, or bad starts. In a cold weather test against another major brand, Champion Copper Plus spark plugs continued to fire and start long after the others had fouled and stopped. And you'll find them at participating True Value hardware stores and home centers.
How you doing, everybody? This is Chet Kopick of Channel 5 Sports. Coming up at 10 p.m. tonight on our Channel 5 News. It's a big day for sports. We'll have complete World Series highlights. St. Louis Cardinals versus Milwaukee Brewers. We'll also update all those college football scores. Keep you posted on the Chicago Bulls and the Chicago Blackhawks. Don't forget, for the action, highlights, interviews, Sports 5 is the place you want to be. See you tonight at 10 p.m. on Chicago's Channel 5 News.
WMAQ.
Somebody's got to win and somebody's got to lose. And this afternoon it was the Milwaukee Brewers' turn to win, and the St. Louis Cardinals can be proud of the fact that they kept it so close. It was a kooky kind of a game where lots of things were happening, lots of runs scored in peculiar ways, but that's what the game is all about. And it's our special pleasure yesterday when the Cardinals have won to bring you a kid who was so humble and so sincere, and this afternoon to bring you of the same stripe, young Mr. Bob McClure, whose faith and serenity has carried him through in the best possible way. And in this kind of a life and in this kind of world where we occasionally concentrate too much on me first and what the other guy's doing and what we can do to get the better of them, it's nice that there are still nice people in national events like this, and you can all see the proof of it in these two nice young kids we brought you. Well, CBS Radio Sports has been happy to bring you the fourth game of the 1982 World Series. Today's broadcast has been sponsored by Honda, maker of Civic, Accords, and the Prelude, by the U.S. Army Reserve, by Jartran Truck Rental, by Quasar Television, Audio, and Appliance Products, by Motorcraft Automotive Products. Our engineers today have been Steve Kirsch and Colin Jarrett. Our producer is David Kerman. Frank Miller is the executive producer for CBS Radio Sports. Be sure to join us again tomorrow for Game 5. It's the Cardinals and the Brewers. Airtime Eastern, 4:35, 3:35 Central, 1:35 Pacific Time. And once again, the final score of the fourth game of the World Series, the Brewers the winners this time, 7-5. Along with Vin Scully and Sparky Anderson, I'm Win Elliott, and from County Stadium in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, it's so long for CBS Radio Sports.
Hawk Baseball with Pearsall, after the game on WMAQ.